party of 1,014 nudes. I am slowly growing her career to where I can fade away and just collect my royalties.
Alex, can you bring me some vodka?
Love you, Father. Wubby.
Can you bring me some vodka?
My body is ready. Yeah.
Some of y'all need to go jerk off. Some of y'all in chat, I can fix her. What the fuck? Some of y'all need to jerk off and come before you do anything, bro. Leave the stream. Come. Come back to the stream, bro. You can. What do you mean you can? When you see a woman you don't agree with on the internet, your first thought is, I can fix her. Bro. Whoa, what are all these cameras, bro? What are all these cameras, bro? Yo, before we start, what's a song like Plain Jane? What can I give Eddie Murphy a do-rag to and we would all jam out? What could I give Well, give me a good one.
Yo mama. 11 months of forgetting about that
Into Club.
Baby Tyler.
Sticky by Drake.
I sold my grandma's house and car to pay for this. Love you mommy. Beating heart.
I feel like before Drake put something like this out, he like bleaches the fuck out of his asshole. I just picture, y'all seen those TikToks where that like gay dude dances around who kind of looks like Andrew Tate from behind? That's who I picture is putting out that music. I'm not, listen, I'm just, Alluux! Bleached assholes again. Here we are again, dude. It's Wednesday. Talking about bleached assholes. Wu-Tang, All Right by Kenny. We're past it, boys. The moment passed. It's over. It's all over. Still tipping. Word of the day. Oh my god, we should do a word of the day. We haven't done a word of the day in so many days, bro. Dwayne, thank you for the 20. Thank you for the subs that came in. Gecko, thank you for the 10, bro. Dwayne, thank you for the 20. And Dwayne, you did 10 before 30. Thank you, bro. You don't have to do that. Watch Chainsaw Man. I know, dude. I know. I want to watch it. But I don't want to do the week-to-week thing. I can't do the week-to-week thing. Bleach your asshole on stream. I'm going to be honest. I don't know the process of bleaching an asshole. I've never done it. I've nared my asshole and I chemically burned my asshole. But I don't know what the process of bleaching. Dude, it's so good. Are you talking about bleaching or are you talking about Chainsaw Man? Watching while I pack. Can we greet each other, chat, before we get into this? Chat, hello. How are you? It's good to see you. With kiss, maybe. How am I? Good. How are you? 32 months. I do that so often. Where I say, oh, how you doing? And they go, good. How are you? And I go, good. How are you? And it's like, oh, I just asked. Clearly, I wasn't paying attention. Oh, I don't know how to talk to you. Blink-182 is back. Didn't the dude get, like, hella cancer? Dude, okay. I don't know what happened. Good, how are you? It's an infinite loop. We die on the street there because we can't escape. Balls. I'm good, how are you? I'm good, how are you? I can't stop. Guys, we have to... Fuck that. That's all my office small talk. Dude, okay, you work in an office. I'm talking to you right now. Do you have this problem? I have this problem. Total, complete lack of care about any coworkers. I was at work... To get paid, to show up, to leave. They would go out, they would hang out outside of work, they would even hang out at lunch together. Nope, I'm in my car, I'm watching my podcast, I'm at work. I would get off at 4:30, that's why stream starts at 5:30. It took me an hour to get home. It's been that way for a while. Anyway, who cares? It made me feel so weird, but like, I'm like, dude, we're not friends. We don't share interests. We work at the same slave place, bro. What do you mean? Watch Cyberpunk Edgerunners. I will. I've heard good things. I've also heard some bad things. I heard it looks really good. That's consistent. Did you lose your old glasses? I swear on me mom's life. Okay? I'll pay you back. I'm just locked out of my account. No, I swear I don't know where my glasses are. I have no clue. I lost them. I could get new ones, but I like these right now anyway. Just get up and do the Ludwig dance already. Almost a year. You show me what the Ludwig dance is and I'll do it. Edgerunners is incredible. I bet it's under your desk. Dude, it's not. I take good care of my glasses. That's why I don't know where they could have gone, to be honest. Anyway. My coworkers are hot girls my age. That's fair. I got along better with my coworkers when I worked at, like, a shitty job where they're all, like, teenagers. But then when I got, like, a big boy adult job and all my coworkers were, like, big boy adults and I was 20, I just wanted to go home. I did not care. People be like excited too. I was oh, no, wait, let's not talk about this. How's NASA doing? Bro, this hat means so much to me. I stole it while I was in Australia, and then it got stolen from me. Hello. By Caleb of Critical's crew when I was with Critical in Florida. And then it finally I got a jerk off crystal. Hold on.
To stay ahead in this bitch off. Drink syrup like it's liquor.
32 months.
Can I play that for you? Because I keep singing it. I keep singing it.
I gotta feed the street. My pistol gonna bleed the street.
What's the name of that song?
I gotta feed the street. But guys, I have content tonight, I swear. My pistol gonna bleed the street.
Sup, my peeps.
I gotta feed the streets. My pistol gonna bleed the streets. Ski mask on my face. Sometimes you gotta cheat. To stay ahead in this bitch, y'all. Drank surf like it's liquor. Street life, I have you catching up to God quicker. Stick off. AK-40 to your lip, off.
chop a bang on you like a blood or a cripple.
Let's get some charges. So much bread, tonight. I'm a gymnast.
Made so much money off the dumbest,
Yeah.
Gang.
Let's make this boy glow!
I'm Mr. Body Catcher, Slaughter Gang Soul Snatcher. Ain't no regular F-150, this a fucking rapper. Yeah. No capper, street nigga, not a rapper. Chopper hit him.
I don't know what the story is on this. This J.O. crystal, I'll wear it. Did you change mics?
No. Hello? Do I sound different?
I don't know what the story is on this J.O. crystal. I think someone gave it to my friend at TwitchCon and said, you need to get this to Wubby. It's the real... Do you guys know what J.O. crystals are? New Channel 5 video? We can watch it. Let me find... Hold on. J.O. crystal nice. Original ad. Where is it? Here it is. Oh my god. It feels, you know, now that I compare it, it feels so authentic. Vegas meet up when? This is how people die, by the way. I'm looking at the original ad. Of course this is in Houston, bro. Of course this is in Houston, bro. Is anyone surprised? Oh my god. I've never died. You probably don't use Craigslist. Charge up NJO 38 Houston. God. Damn. What's Ham saying? Some guy ran into me at Artist Alley and was like, yo, Ham, where's Wubby? And he gave me the crystal and said I'd understand. He said Wubby would understand. So I gave it to Linux, who gave it to DJ, who's given it... Okay, so it's been charged at least 4 times. So this has passed through at least 4 man's hands. And I can... You know, when I grabbed it, I'll say this. There was a weight to it. There was a... Like... I felt like you were passing me years of suffering. It felt heavy, but in a metaphorical sense. Concept of weight, but not... It wouldn't tip the scale. Do you understand what I'm saying? It also smelled like dick. I don't know what that is. Charge up in J.O. Come on, you know this. The crystal I wear around my neck contains an essence that gets recharged when I jack it with a bro who also has a crystal. So wait, we need 2 crystals to make this happen? It gives me... Dude, this is literally... See, crystal girls are cute and it affects their auras. Crystal dudes are pedophiles. It gives me confidence at work, home, social situations. Wow. Nobody knows it's a J.O. crystal but me and my bros. I've said... This is it right here, guys. Actually, you know what? I'm not even lying. This is true. Peanut, Carlos... Oh, let me get rid of the score. Peanut, Carlos, DJ, whoever in San Diego. If you get a crystal, I'm willing to masturbate with you back to back. This is not a lie. I am willing to masturbate with you back to back on stream behind a green screen so nobody can see to see if it'll actually glow. Because, you know, you can't... I'm not going to sit here and shit on this guy's, like, beliefs if I've never back to back jerked off with a friend. With a crystal. Lettuce, you down? We could do it. Okay, well, here's the thing, right? Are we prepared for if it actually starts glowing? What do you do then? Allow me to continue. Nobody knows. I've seen it glow. That's how I know it's real. See, this guy, I'm gonna be honest, this guy could have been us, right? He could have been the guy who got roped into the, it's not real. And then it starts to glow. Then what do you do? Now what, huh? Suddenly you're this guy. Onwards and forwards. That's right. You can come over for as long as... Dude, this is some dumb... I've been watching that Dahmer show. This is straight up Dahmer shit. Just come over. I'm just going to take a couple photos. I'll give you $50. No, it's just soap in the cup. It's just soap. Just drink it. Just you can come over as long as you want. I need a picture of you wearing the crystal before I waste my time, though. It glows if you get married. Oh, jeez. Oh, boo. Boo. Literally finished watching it tonight and got Dahmer vibes too. Can I be honest? I've been really liking the Dahmer show on Netflix. Okay. Can I give a small complaint? I don't think that the... Okay. And I'm going to be very clear. I am a man who... My intelligence is above most of yours. I'm smarter than a lot of you. Using my prime intel. I'm more talented than a lot of you. So when I watch the show... I can watch the show
and from a place that a lot of Netflix norm. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna bring this in. Actually, I'm gonna rope you guys back in. Okay, we are this community. Thank you, Mutiki Weasel. This community here. Watch. I'm gonna get you guys on my side. This community is smarter than everyone in my chat right now. You guys are smarter than most normies, right? Your fucking, your brain dead mother is gonna tune into Netflix, right? And all her dumb friends are, right? These normie idiots. We are smart. And here's my worry about the new I can't say his name. The new Jeffrey show. Here's my concern about it. I watch it. Alluux is watching it. She doesn't know anything about him. So this is all coming out. And I'm like, no, you just wait. He is the pure essence of evil. This man is so evil, right? But I'm scrolling TikTok now, and you want to know what I'm seeing on my For You page? Jeffrey fucking Dahmer fan cam shit. I'm like, guys, listen, this man fucking murdered, tortured, raped so many people. I mean, the dude was lobotomizing people while they were alive to turn them into human sex zombies. I'm gonna say this. I love the show. I don't think the world can handle the show. I don't think they can handle it. Because Jeffrey Dahmer and the actor playing him happen to be, I guess, reasonably attractive, people cannot handle it. They can't handle it. Red Letter Media? What about them? I haven't finished the show yet, so I haven't watched the review, if that's what you're referencing. So I'm waiting. I don't know. The hashtag Dahmer challenge. Because I'm watching the show, and they're starting to paint Dahmer. I'm like episode 4 or 5. They're starting to, by the way, go watch it. It's on Netflix. They're starting to paint him like a victim. And it's like, oh, he's getting bullied in school. And I'm like, there's probably people out there who are watching this right now going, oh man, he's getting bullied in school. I'm like, yeah, he did get bullied. And then he murdered 16 people and drilled holes in their brains and ate their heart. I would have bullied him. Bully this fucking man. He's not a victim of his surrounding. The dude is evil. 17 people. Thank you. The dude is evil. He was fucking kids, dude. He was crazy. I don't care that his mom was a pill addict and his dad was abusive, bro. He was fucking sucking blood and cutting up people because Viscera turned him on. No! No! Okay, and you? What are you saying, weirdo? What are you saying? Another month, another one. Hey, man, that's a spoiler. Bro, it's been 30 years. What do you mean? Are you kidding me? Really? A spoiler? Seriously, we used the metal in the nonsense. He killed 17 trying to make him a living zombie. Yeah, I know, because he didn't want people to leave. Oh, he's crazy, bro. Zoomer spoilers? Yeah, exactly. I'm surprised even Zoomers don't know who he is. Okay, you know what? This guy in chat just sold me on it. I take it all back. He said, don't yuck his yum, bro. All right, respect. Hey, valid. For real. Hey, that's valid. No, you're right. I ain't gonna yuck his yum. You're right. For real. Time gone. I'm getting so old. Please help me. It's okay, man. We can all just do a group suicide at one point. I'll put out the message. You guys will know. You'll know. I'll make it very clear. We just. Nesim Chabas. Thank you for the 10 subs, bro. Appreciate you. Anyway, go watch the show. It's really good. Am I still wearing my JL crystal? We'll see if it'll glow tonight, huh? Have I talked to you guys about Caleb, this idea Caleb had? Have I talked to you guys about it? He really wants me to do it, and he's dead serious. Have I talked to you about this green screen idea Caleb has? Do you want me to tell you? Okay, I'm going to tell you. So Caleb, who works with Critical, that's how we know each other. I met him through him. I worked with him on the Amaranth show thing we did. He has this idea that he's pushing me to do, to the point where I have a Twitlonger in the drafts, just in case he pisses me off one day. But he's been pushing me for this day. And here's the thing. I'm going to say this idea, and you're going to think I'm joking. He has cornered me and said, I'm serious. You say the word, we're doing this. Okay, you ready for this idea? Here's what he wants to do. We have learned that having sex on Twitch gets you a 3-day suspension, at worst a 7-day. We've learned that. That's in the books. Okay, a couple had sex on stream. Okay. His idea, he is dead serious. He wants him and I to get in green screen suits. One of us is going to be a bottom. One of us is going to be a top. Okay, you just see our heads.
my butthole or my dick, his butthole or his dick, will be cut out of the green screen suit, painted green. Okay? We're gonna walk on frame in front of a green screen in a room, okay? And we are, I'm not lying, he said we are going to have gay sex. Now, I don't, here's the thing, right? I don't think that he is, you know, a gay man. I have never seen somebody, when I went to hang out with him in Florida, he was like, bro, I'm serious at TwitchCon. If you want to make it happen, we can make it happen. He's like, this will propel both of our careers into the fucking stratosphere. This is not a joke. And then here's how I know he was serious. Here's how I know he's serious. He goes, bro, I'm serious. If you don't want to fuck me, we can bring a third party in and I can paint them green and we can do it. But as long as we do it on your stream, it'll be huge. He is so fucking serious. Here's my problem with it, right? I've voiced a couple concerns with him. What green paint is safe to get in your asshole? And what green paint is gonna be strong enough to hold up against, like, sex? Lettuce wants to do it. I know Lettuce would. You have to understand, we are hiding our genitals cannot be seen. I do think they'll be able to get us on a longer ban if at any point the green starts to rub off. But like, if the more you think about it, the crazier it gets, right? That means if it's a girl, she's gotta have a completely green pussy inside out. If it's a dude's ass, his butthole cavity has to be green at least 5.5 inches. Just tattoo it, what the fuck? All right, we're going full commitment. Never mind, I'm not gonna go there. Just do doggy from a front angle. That's what we were gonna do. What, hold on. You just said do doggy from a front angle like you're saying something. Bro, what did you think it was gonna be? Did you think it was gonna be like top down angle missionary? What the fuck were you thinking it was gonna be? It's gonna be just like this, except there's gonna be a floating head behind me and I'm gonna be getting pounded. So here's, and then Caleb has this whole thing set up too. He goes, if they ban us, okay, they're homophobic. If they ban us, they're anti-LGBT. He's got this whole fucking plan. Oh, if they don't, and we gotta lean into it, dude. We had gay sex. We are gay. It's a thing. It's crazy. I don't know what. Listen. And then here's the other thing. If they don't ban us, we were the two dudes who fucked on stream and got away with it. It's actually genius. No, guys, you're supposed to say Wubby. I want you to distance yourself from this man. Why are you the bottom in this scenario? I'm gonna be honest with you. I think it's less gay to get fucked in the ass than to fuck a dude's ass. I do. I think, and I will actually get on call with anybody. I think it is less gay to get fucked in the ass by a man than fuck a man's ass. Okay, chat didn't like that, huh? Alluux, when you have a chance, can you bring me the vodka, please? Here we go. Maybe let's just watch. Hey, how about we just watch a video, huh? How about we do anything else? You're gay, bro? I kind of agree. Ham! Yes! I don't... Okay, I feel like if I'm just kind of sitting here, like, playing games, and a man comes up and fucks my ass, okay? Me letting it happen is... I'm not making any choice. I'm letting it happen. I'm sitting here. I'm busy. Maybe I'll clean it up in a second, okay? I'm gonna skip your video because we're just gonna watch it. We're just gonna watch it. Thank you. But if you're the dude pitching from, hey Alluux, what is this bottle? You came bottle no cork and it's nearly empty. Yeah, it's gross. I catch flies with that one. What do you want? What's up? How you doing? Yeah, no, I'm asking you how you doing. Here we go. Okay, hold on. Let me pause this. Hold on. Thank you, Voodoo guy. Appreciate the 50 months. Go ahead. What's up? I've been trying to explain. Maybe if you put your fucking listening ears on.
Maybe if I didn't have to get up and use vodka.
Oh, so it's gonna be like that today, huh? Don't look, I just dropped something. Okay, can I explain? Fucking a dude's ass is an active it's an activity. You're choosing with every stroke to put your penis every second into a man's butt. You are physically doing that. Okay. If I'm getting fucked in the ass, maybe I'm busy. Maybe I'm on an important... let me finish. Maybe I'm on an important business call. Maybe I'm raiding. Maybe I'm in an Overwatch game. Maybe I'm in a CS game.
So what? You're just taking a whole ass dick in your ass and you're like barely even paying attention to it?
No, maybe. I'll
lose your ass. What the fuck you mean? You're just like asleep? Are you good?
All right.
That's not funny, you know. We've come a long way since the 90s, Alluux. You know that, right?
Who's we?
The gay, me and the gay community. Why are you stepping on my rug?
Because it's a rug.
Okay, that's... Do you want to show it to chat?
Yeah.
Here, come show it to chat.
Yeah,
it's cool.
I'm in my gym.
Well, who cares? Well, there's a hole in it, so make sure your pussy lips aren't out.
Can you just fucking hang? Hello?
Do you like my rug?
You just see my crotch.
Do you like my rug, chat? Wait, show him the other one. Show him the other one.
What other one?
The other one that's over there. They like it. They're pogging me. Someone said ew. Well, I have a Modern Warfare 2 one coming too.
Why are you sitting this all fucking?
It's all folded. I know. Well, can you God give it a little? You know, make it look pretty. the ice cream.
I will make it look pretty.
Okay, jeez. Look at this one. It's an ice cream cone that's been spilled. Why are you flopping it? They don't do that in the wild.
I'm making it look better. I'm making it look like it's less crunched because if I'm moving it, it looks like it's just being wobbled.
When's the room makeover? Yeah, I don't know. Okay, thank you, Alluux. All right. You done? Can I go? Okay, you're done. All right. Why it's so stiff on the end? I don't know, bro. How charged would you like the how charged would the J.O. crystal get if you got fucked in the ass? I feel like the J.O. crystal might explode. Arabic couch win. Alright, Booty is on vacation. Guys, listen, I want you to hear my words very carefully. Booty is on, he is gone. Booty is going to be gone for this entire week. Booty gets back next week, okay? My entire life. Everything is on hold right now because I can barely wipe my ass properly. And not to mention, okay, the reason why we're doing Cringe You Drink tonight, which is right after Laugh You Lose, it's like, why are you doing them so close together? Because Alluux is also going to be gone this week. So we're, boys, not only is it going to be a boys' night for the rest of the week, it's going to be a, I'm kind of scared at alone night the rest, alone night, yeah. I don't even know. Boys' week? So boys, tonight is the last night. We're using Alluux before she goes. And then we're on our own for the next couple streams. I don't know what we're gonna do. You, Alluux is gone. I'll be like, oh Booty, let's come up with a game. Booty's gone. Oh, okay, Alluux, we'll do something. We'll do like Laugh You Lose. They're both gone. Guys, where is my content? I guess I'll play Melee for 4 hours. I don't know. Maybe I'll do coke on stream. It's going to be bad. I really don't think I'm going to be able to do this without getting banned. Beauty and the Geek. I guess that's a good idea. We can do that on Friday. That's not a bad idea. Do you guys want to do Phil Kid Friday on Friday? I don't know. We're going to be making so many mistakes, though. That's for damn sure. Watch the Minx video? Wait, wait, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, Miko video. All right, well, we are getting drunk tonight, though. So might as well start, huh? It's been a couple days since I was drunk for 5 days.
Lucky number
we, can, we do a little drinking. What can I say? We do a little drinking, huh? Gamble with coke. Okay, this is my promise. And you can clip this and send this to Alluux for when I'm... Okay. The only rule I have while Alluux and Booty are out of the house, I cannot gamble. No gambling. There is no, do not let me gamble. We can do anything else. I'll have fun in any way. We cannot gamble. With nobody here to make me feel shame when I lose money. Why am I, don't boo me. What happened? Why am I getting booed for that? Hey man, wanna play some poker? Please, can we play poker? We should do a poker night. We should do a poker night here. Just the boys. Oh my God, just the boys because all the bitches are gone and Booty. It's actually just Booty and Alluux. Oh my God. We should do a poker night. I've been wanting to do a, like a real poker night at the house with like a bunch of cameras and GoPros and everything. Oh. I lost a lot of poker or a lot of money in poker at TwitchCon. There was a poker set up at a party with real money and we played and I lost everything. I lost what I sat down with entirely. And I think DJ 4X'd what he sat down with. That sucked. Professional poker setup. It'd be so fun. Let me watch the rich man lose money. Listen, brother, let me tell you something about rich man losing money, okay? I don't care how rich you are. Losing money gambling stings the same, all right?
Boy does it haunt me on the way to my car after a long casino night. Let me tell you, bro. Whoo, laddie. Atlas, thank you for the 5 subs. And then I go live and you guys make me feel better and give me subs, so thank you. Do a scary game for Halloween. I'm glad you brought that up. I have some big content announcements I'm going to make right now. I'm retiring. $1 billion, that's going to happen. I have some content announcements. Finally, what do you mean finally? When I retire, you better cry. There better be like a hashtag cut for Wubby thing going on Twitter or something. I swear to God, if you guys are just, if hashtag and nothing of value was lost gets trending, that would hurt more than nothing getting trending, right? Don't do that. You better cry. I better get videos of you crying on the subreddit. Hashtag nothing of value lost. Now that I said that, you guys are gonna, that's why part of me doesn't even want to announce retirement. Just stop showing up. You guys will think I died, which I think I prefer. Anyway, content announcement. I was supposed to announce this a while ago. I really fucked up. I really did. Booty, are you there? Or Peanut, are you there? Who can edit the subreddit posts? It's very important. I need you guys to edit the subreddit posts. Okay. Husband and friend spit roast me and use me however they feel. Sorry, I'm just reading what's on my Reddit. Okay. On the subreddit, we're going to put a new pinned post. What? I'll make a dedication video. I want you to print out a photo of me, put it in a jar, and a jack on it. So, this Halloween, okay, we're going to put an official post on the subreddit based on what I say right now. But I go live. I'm live on Halloween. I don't know if it falls on a stream day. But the due date will be the day after Halloween. So I'll let you have fun on Halloween, but you need to take a photo. But we are doing a PaymoneyWubby Extended Universe Costume Contest for this Halloween. We've never done it, but I think there's enough of you that watch, and we have enough stupid things here. So we're going to have a cash prize for the winner, okay? Cash prize for the winner, whoever gets first place. We will do a voting system where we will vote for the best costume, whoever deserves it the most. Now, keep in mind, the people who are going to try, your peers, these idiots in chat are going to be voting. So, yeah, you could spend the next 2 weeks and $10,000 making an amazing costume. But remember, the dude who just is me in a green screen suit with his balls out might win. So, what are the rules? Who can you dress up as? Anybody from the Wubby Extended Universe. If you have to ask if somebody's in that universe, I wouldn't dress up as them. Because remember, you're getting voted by people in chat, people on Discord, people who are watching the stream. Okay, they're not watching the stream. Okay? So, am I making a submission thread? Yes. Yes, you will submit in the thread just a photo, maybe a brief description of who you are, whatever. I've already had people ask me, Wubby, can I do this person? Wubby, it's like, yeah, you can. And I think obscurity, there's going to be this fine line, right? Where it's obscure enough, but people still find it funny and know what it is. I think the losers want me to make it. Yes, please, Booty, please make it. All right, here's what you shouldn't do, all right? I'm Wubby, and you buy a green screen suit. Don't do that. That's going to waste everybody's time. Get creative with it. There's so many options here, guys. There's so many characters we've talked to in this extended universe. All right? I will give you guys a brief description with your costume. The name of it will be that description. So if you're dressed up as that dude who got really high on stream and works in a strawberry plant, that could be your name. But keep in mind, that's all you get to say. Tan face Wubby. Wubby Extended Universe, anything from my old YouTube, my highlight channel, stream, Twitter, people we've interacted with, has to be TOS friendly because I have to show it on stream. But if you want to have a naked version for us on the subreddit, I ain't gonna stop you. Anyway, really excited for that. And then on stream, we're gonna go through it all. I hope you guys don't let me down. I don't know how creative you guys are. I don't know how cosplay, you know, mindset you guys are. But I hope we get some good ones at least. What's going to be the cash prize? That's a good question. God, it really... What number I throw out right now is really going to determine who involves himself or not. What's enough to get people out of bed? $20? Okay, that's embarrassing. 2.7K? I'm going to be pissed, though. If I offer $2,700 for first place, if I offer that, okay, and then you guys show up with shit and a dude who wrote Costco hot dog on his forehead wins. In fact, you know what, Booty? If anybody does that, just ban them now. We're going to get ahead of that right now. Emiru is doing a 30K cash prize. What a fucking idiot. That's crazy. What do you mean 30K, bro? What is she made of money? What? Is it more racist or ableist to be subbed? Man, it's you should do it. Can we low effort win? You can try. 30K. Okay, hey, guess what, guys? You might want to enter in her contest because we ain't fucking doing that. Get it sponsored? Okay, cash prize to be determined if I can get a sponsor. 30K is crazy, though. 30K is... I 30K is more than what I imagine, like, actual cosplay events contests do. That's great. 30 fucking K? That's, like, more than I get paid for a sponsor. Oh, it's a 30K pool? Okay, I'm starting to learn there's more and more going on now. Hold on. Okay, so what's really going on? Top prize at San Diego Comic-Con is, like, 5K. Okay, well, there you go. All right. I can ask... I'm not gonna read that. All right, I will get back to you guys. If we get a sponsor, I'll make it more. If we don't get a sponsor, 1 to 2K for first place. Okay, that's not bad. This isn't that serious. Don't go make like crazy fucking $800 wings. Nobody cares. This is all for fun. 1 to 2K. If I can get a sponsor, we'll put that into the pool. We'll see what we can do. Maybe Adam and Eve will throw something on it. Most cringe award costume. Exactly, exactly. All right, there you go.
26 months. Jesus, what a waste of money.
See, how much do you owe Jayshla? I don't like 10K.
Hi, Wubby, hi, chat.
I already spent the 30K. You ruined me.
5 months hard.
Okay, that's good. That's funny. 5K, we all heard it. That's you heard it here first. How did you spend 30K that fast? I went straight to the car dealership. I got my car detailed today for the first time in my entire life. Did you know that? Do you guys care? And it was very nice and smelled very good and it looked very good. I didn't realize, I this is my poverty brain still at work here. I have been under the impression that, okay, I don't care. Okay, I'll stop talking then. Anything else you want? Weird flex, but okay. Up until now, I was under the impression, like I knew this wasn't true, but I don't ever think that far ahead. I was like, okay, when your car gets poopy on the inside, It just poopy now. That's how I've always worked. That's how my brain has always operated. When your car gets poopy on, like, my seats are white and they started to get dirty. No, I didn't poop in it, guys. And they started to get, you know, kind of worn. And that's just the way it is. You should see the seats in my dad's car growing up. Just tearing. I didn't know that you could just take it in for, like, routine scrubbing and they send, like, fucking 10 dudes in there and you get in your car and it's like brand new. I had no clue. I thought you'd go to fucking Soapy Joe's and a small Mexican man would come out with used dish rags, wipe down the outside, and then you get one of those vacuums that they have hooked up and just that looks okay. Guess how much I paid. It was interior detailing and exterior detailing, top to bottom. Okay, see, you know what? I didn't do bad. I paid $250, and I went to the dealership that is of my vehicle. $250. $9 million. Decent. And I would do it again. I don't wash my car. So I would say, what, like doing this once, twice a year maybe? That's not bad. Overpaid! Do not talk shit about my boy, Soapy Joe. My brother in Christ, Soapy Joe has been my best mate for 5-6 years now. My car's looking gross. Take it in, Soapy Joe, $15. It still looks like shit. Dude, I'm sorry, guys, but if you're washing your car for a cheap amount, let me be very clear to you, you're just wasting your money. It is so not worth it. You are throwing your money away. Just let your car get dirtier and save those $15 up. Trust, you're waste. You're throwing your money away. I'm telling you, I will go to Soapy Joe's. Okay, I will get the Mexican scrub down, and that shit looks so good for about 8 seconds. I get on the fucking road, I roll down my window, psh, water falling in. I'm using windshield wipers. Maybe in Cali, not where salt trucks are. What is that? I don't even know what that. What's a salt truck? Your privilege is showing. I'm telling you, for the first time in my life, I got my car detailed. For the first time in my entire life, I could have got my car detailed 4 years ago. Ever heard of snow? I've actually never seen snow. Swin Diesel, thank you for the five, bro. Salt trucks ice the road. I don't even know what any of those words mean. What are you guys saying? What? I've never seen snow in real life. This is gonna get people all riled up. I've seen small amount of snowflakes falling from the sky when I was in New York. Get this man some snow, stat. Yeah, I've never seen snow. I've never jumped into a snow thing and done the angle thing. I've never peed in my life. Dingleberry, Barry, Jerry, how you doing, Jerry? My old boss's name was Jerry. She was a fucking bitch. Everyone daydreamed about hitting her with their car. Chelsea, thank you for the 10. I only have good things to say about Chelsea. I got a snow guy, don't worry. Oh, I've seen snow. I've smelled snow, bro. We're at the club. Never mind. But I've never thrown a snowball. I've never made a snowman. Whenever I go somewhere cold, I have to buy cold clothes there because I don't own any. New York snow. This is so sad. Bro, I don't even want to hear it, okay? Hold on. Is snow Mexican a racial slur? Never mind. Alluux is very accustomed to snow being from Canada. And let me make it very clear. As beautiful as she will say snow is, she can't even finish her same sentence without bringing up how disgusting snow is. Snow is, here's it, watch. I'm gonna pretend like I know snow. Hey, where are my snow guys at? Bro, dude, black ice? Dude, I hate black ice. What's another one? Oh, dude, I love snow right when it's falling, and then it gets so dirty. Ugh, and the traffic is worse. Ugh, I hate it. It gets so gross when the snow gets dirty. Ugh, like it literally, it snows, it's beautiful, and then it gets hard and muddy, and the city gets all horrible and chains. Ugh, and like I gotta, you know, I hate the. Did I do it? Did I convince you guys? Oh, my driveway. I gotta wait for the city to clear the fucking road so I can get to work in my driveway. Ugh. You went too far with the chains. I never took a shot, did I?
God damn it. God damn it.
I made my ex put his cock in the snow. Once, just for bants. God, my penis would not leave an imprint on the snow. I feel like you could take your pinky and a thimble, and it would have a very similar imprint. Nobody asked. That's what I'm saying. It's not alcoholism if you're making money at the same time. Bro, tell that to Bam. What do you mean? Careful, Destiny got banned for less. Did he? What? Where's the content? I don't know. Let's see who's live right now. I'll point you in the right direction, brother. All right, let's watch this. Okay, what do we have here? Channel 5? Do you want to watch Channel 5? Oh, dude. Because of Critical's new video today, I have been on an absolute Criss Angel rabbit hole. We'll talk about Criss Angel after this, but I used to be. There's possible TOS moments in the new video? What do you mean? Hold on, let me 2 minutes 17 to 2 minutes 22. Oh my god, their penises are out.
Pull it down.
Oh my god, he's pulling on his fucking penis. How do I watch this? How do I watch? Okay, Peanut messaged me. How do I watch this? Hey, someone sent this to me. You probably already went through it. I haven't. I love that you assume. You assume that I screen anything I show on stream. Bro, I am begging for like a 3-day vacation. Are you kidding me? Okay, hold on. Let's look at this. Hey, so you probably went through it, but if you haven't, the new Andrew Callahan video has some sussy timestamps. Hassan has been watching it, and it's been fine. Well, then we're good. Listen, we're good. Hassan's been watching it. But at 4:24 in particular, he even got scared at that one. 6:28 to 6:58 shows a PP as a chart with colors. Hold on, wait. Hold on, let me see if that one. Another one with a little penis. Oh, that's fine. That's fine. That's fine. Is that a real penis?
Blurry. So basically, we massaged each other's heart.
Oh, God. Okay, 4:24 spread butt cheeks. Guys, do we want to watch this?
Do it though, the more you spend time with each other too, the more you can actually just observe and-
Oh my god! Oh my god! Ladies and gentlemen, okay, I'm just gonna do this, just, you know what? It's like a band-aid, right? You just gotta take it off, you know? It's just, it's, now that the band-aid's off, here's what I'm gonna say. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to heed the words. Am I using heed correctly? Listen to me very carefully, okay? Here's what I'm going to say. Here's what I'm going to say. See you in seven. Bro, if this gets me 7-day ban, okay, that means I could have had fucking intercourse on stream and been banned for less. All right? You ask every time you say it. You know what I really hate? Okay, I'm just a man. I'm just a simple dude. I'm a guy. I don't think too much. I just talk. I hang out, but there's some of you, you got fucking spreadsheets of how many times I say certain words, okay? I don't know. That's true, look at E-Rob. What about E-Rob? What's wrong with E-Rob? All right, I'm gonna play this video. At 327 to 350 is almost certainly TOS. Let me see.
So this is Shivambu.
I need to call my people. Hold on. I need to call my people real quick. Hey guys, I just need a temp check. Do I watch this video?
Yeah, the guide that dude sent me seemed pretty comprehensive.
No, but Pina, I'm thinking about just going in no guide.
Yeah. I don't know. Is crusty cum
papers
bad?
Well, that's like guaranteed.
What did Peanut just ask?
Crusty cum papers is what the guy sent to me.
I don't know what
that
is.
That just sounds like a good time. What?
I don't know what he's asking. What is a crusty cum paper?
Like dried cum.
Let me look. Semen? It's at. I'm aware. I'm at 15:30. Hold on.
My buddy Brian did a new moon ejaculation ritual.
Oh my god, bro! What is this?
We let go of, and we ejaculated onto.
Yeah, I don't know.
Dog, did Hassan watch this? Did he get to the crusty cum?
Just put a post-it note on your monitor. That way, no one will see it.
I mean, Booty brings up a strong point here.
Hold on. Let me look at some of these. Oh, that's kind of a butt.
At where?
18-16, like the guy said. It's like a hint of a butt. It's a shadow of an
no,
ass.
No, that's an ass.
Whoa. That, yeah.
That's a whole ass. Okay, that's the only one I'm actually nervous about. How could?
What about the spread butt cheeks at 4:24?
I already showed that to chat. Right.
We're past
I already
that.
Showed, I already showed.
There's a blur.
We're past that.
Listen.
Blur. Well, I think you're good then.
Hey, clip that chat. Clip that. And make sure you save it because you won't be able to access my channel in about 2 hours. Listen. By the way, Peanut, we're doing cringe you drink tonight. So if you want the VOD to edit, you might want to just start recording locally because my channel might not exist in a few minutes.
Okay. Yeah, that sounds okay. Good.
Is Adri here? Adri, are you here?
Bye.
Hello.
How are you feeling?
I'm getting there.
Okay. All right. Feel better.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeb, are you here?
I'm here.
Did you finally change?
No.
I hung up. That was so mean. I was kidding. Oh, no. All right. We could watch this. Guys, now chat, before I hit play here, okay, we're all friends, parasocially, we're all here, this is okay. No, you're saying use watch together, you won't have to show it, you don't understand, I want to show it. I want to see it with you. So here are the timestamps I need you, I'm going to put this in chat, I need you guys to keep me honest, okay? I'm putting these in chat, these are the timestamps, I need you guys to keep me honest, okay? So we have 424, spread butt cheeks, 728 to 758, peepee chart. Not worried about that. Here's where things start to get kind of dicey. 1530 to 1545, crusty cum papers. And then 1652 to 1707, more crusty cum. 1742 to 1746, how is there more crusty cum? The big one, I think the one that we really need to be careful of is 816 is just butt. Is just 720, there's a dude's dick swinging? Where?
Use same-sex erotic bonding, superfood nutrition, detoxification to enhance male potency.
I'm not seeing any of that. All right, let's just get, boys, let's just get it, all right? Let's just get this, okay? Here we go. You ready? Let's be brave. We're watching a video. We're gonna be brave. We're gonna be bold. We're men and women. We got this.
I am shameless. I am fearless. I am doubtless. Because fear in the present moment is fear. Fear in the past is shame.
This is beautiful. There is something beautiful about what we're watching.
Fear in the future is doubt. So when you cup another dude's nuts, you're sending good vibrations, good chi, spiraling up the back down the front of each testicle.
Oh yeah, baby!
They're your batteries. So when you focus on your testicles, you're literally charging your batteries. And of course, you're probably the first guy in your family lineage who's doing shit like this, at least for hundreds of years. So of course the shame's gonna come up. Of course the fear's gonna come up.
Guys, my J.O. crystal is gonna be fucking shaking by the end of this video. I actually can't think of a more relevant time to bust out the J.O. crystal than right now.
Of course, the doubt's gonna come up. So I always just tell my students, say, what do your balls feel like right now?
Smile. I can't believe this shit.
Really staying grounded in your nuts and your body and your feet. Good. And then you reach for the nuts and you basically cup the nuts and you appreciate the nuts. Can you kind of feel the Reiki energy leaving my palm chakra into your ball sack?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And we take 3 deep breaths through the mouth. And then you say,
I see you, brother.
I see you, brother.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing. And then you give them a hug.
Nice. You smell good.
Thanks, man. You smell pretty good, too.
My name is Will Blunderfield. We're in my apartment in Vancouver, Canada. And I teach sexual
kung fu. Of course they're from Vancouver.
So it's the daily discipline of harnessing and directing your sexual energy from your loins up into the rest of your system rather than constantly just shooting it out like most guys do. Some people are like, well, you're saying that, you know, you should love yourself as you are. Why are you encouraging guys to grow their cocks? But I'm just saying, let your cock and your balls fully exist in the form that they're meant to exist in beyond
maybe,
the poison.
Maybe this guy's onto something.
That cock size is the smallest it's ever been in recorded history. So my holistic approach is a 3-pillar thing. It's about getting the pesticides and the microplastics out of your body through superfoods and detoxification protocols. Then it's actually sexual kung fu techniques, like pulling, literally like taking the coconut oil and milking your penis down 50 times, up 50 times, left 50 times, right 50 times, and straight up.
Guys, I don't think I'm gonna have a channel at the end of this stream. That blur was running away from his penis. I believe this guy is dancing around the fact of the matter, there's something called jelking, You guys know what jelking is? You ever jelk with your boys? It's the art of pulling on your penis to make it appear longer. God damn it. We really about to get banned. Alluux gonna be gone, booty gonna be gone, and I'm not gonna be able to stream. What am I gonna sit here? I could pull on my penis. 7 days. There's no way they ban, dude. They cannot ban me for longer than a woman who literally got penetrated on their platform, bro. What are we watching? How could it be any more obvious, you bum?
50 times every day. My balls used to be the size of like enlarged, like slightly bigger than an almond, and now they're both the size of like a Brazil nut.
What? And
it's great to be able to feel.
Why were his balls so tiny? Wait, what? An almond? What? My balls are like. My balls are. Like a small golf ball, like small, like maybe like. If you cut a golf ball, I don't know how big a golf ball is. Cut a golf ball in half and then roll it into a ball. A Cadbury cream egg? A cheese puff? Y'all got some baby testes, bro. What do you mean? Wait, your balls are round? Wait, what? Okay, I'm realizing now I don't know a lot about what other dudes' balls look like. A cue ball? A couple grape-sized? I need someone to help me. I'm starting to get scared that I have humongous balls.
Feel that. And it's also great to be able to lengthen the penis.
Easiest way to really come into the penis in terms of lengthening it, you literally just make an okay grip and you just pull it down. The penis and the tongue are the uttermost extensions of the heart. In classical Chinese medicine, you're just like,
Traditionally, you sit naked. My teacher, Montauk Chia, taught me this.
Later on, we're going to talk a lot about screwing technique.
Literally focus your consciousness into your nuts because energy flows where the mind goes. There's also something that my teacher, Troy Casey, taught me. It's called testicle slapping. So you do this for maybe 2 minutes, not too hard, not too easy, just right. Mixing the blood and the chi in your balls, increasing your testosterone, which will increase your manhood. And then you take the energy of nature. Okay, so I don't know why I flushed the toilet, force of habit, but anyway, so this is
there ain't no way Hassan watched this on stream. There ain't no way he watched this on stream. And he just let it play. He just let it play. Hey guys, make sure no matter what happens here, make sure you use code Wubby on gamer subs. Exactly, boys. Yeah, give me a clip. Give me a clip right now. Give me a clip right now if he watched it. Give me a clip right now if he watched it. You're in too deep. Wubby, he didn't. What do you mean? Why are you guys still like this? All right, so here we have Will Blunder. I love that in his name is the word blunder. That's ironic. Thank you, Harvey, for the 25. Tell me this isn't Megamind right now. So Megamind just came out of the bathroom, and he, I want to be very clear here, he is holding apple juice. This is all a bit. I'm friends with him. I'm friends with everyone in this video. This is a bit. He's drinking apple juice.
Shivambu. It's good.
He is chugging this apple juice. It is spilling down his beard.
Oh, I got in my beard. I eat carrots, organic carrots, because they make me feel good. I drink my piss because it makes me feel good.
Can you tell us what?
Isn't like the book kind of closed on drinking pee? Like, aren't we like scientifically there that drinking pee is like objectively not something you should do? And you know, I feel like he didn't even have to drink his pee. He told me he drinks organic or eats organic carrots. Like that, like if, like as if that's anything. Dude, we have anti-vaxxers. Yeah, but I feel like drinking your pee, I feel like we're there, dude. His pee was also very, very yellow. That's why I know it wasn't pee.
What same-sex erotic bonding is.
Yeah, same-sex erotic bonding is when two men or a group of men come together to do things that this culture would say would be like homosexual. For example, two men hugging heart-to-heart with the cocks touching, breathing, and doing our best to stay in a parasympathetic state of being rather than going into stress mode.
The first time was definitely really challenging to really be present with actually observing my brother's body and being present with him watching me. The more you do it though, the more you spend time with each other too, the more you can actually just observe and witness the person for everything they've gone through. It's no different than any other part of their body, so why not give them some appreciation, send them some love.
Brother, you've got a beautiful cock.
You got a beautiful cock, baby.
Thanks, brother.
Got you.
And then you hug heart to heart because the heart is on the left side of the body.
Hey, Kelly, thanks for the 5 subs. You have a beautiful cock, Kelly.
With the cocks touching.
When I started hanging out with these guys, and it's not just Will, there's other people in Vancouver who are also engaging in these kind of practices. My assumption was like,
holy,
oh, they must be gay. Oh, they must want something from me. It took a few years to finally build that trust with these guys.
Oh, we have a Hassan clip. Yes! Okay, wait, he did do it! He did do it! He did do it! Load! Oh my god, and Austin is there?
Okay. So...
Okay, we're good. We're watching this whole fucking... I'm not cutting away, dude. We're watching this whole fucking thing, bro. Are you kidding me? It's right there for the taking. Are you kidding me? We're good. I'm gonna drink my own pee right now. What the fuck?
That... Oh, they're not trying to, like, subtly manipulate me and...
November.
Maybe they are gay underneath, but they're not acknowledging it.
Whether we call ourselves gay or straight or trans, like... We think that these labels make us all so unique and that they're so important, when really, to me, they're just tools that the Matrix uses
based.
To divide us and control us.
Based,
because I feel like we're so much more than just one little word. But if you're gonna call me something, call me a faggot. And then Facebook censors go off and I'm in Facebook jail now for 30 days. Plus, I talk about...
Where did that come from? What the fuck? We could have played bingo with that and nobody would have gotten it. Nobody would have saw that shit coming.
Medical freedom, so it's like a double whammy for me.
On my club, the wild naked man denies the existence of viruses.
Oh,
and
no.
He just like talks about all this crazy shit that I didn't learn about, and I've been going to med school for 5 generations, okay?
Did you actually read the links that I sent?
Oh my god, just accept that you're gay. You're gay, honey.
The word that I was called most in high school was faggot. And I just love the intensity of that word. And I guess it's like how some black people reappropriate the N-word.
Yeah.
I like to reappropriate the faggot.
So you experienced like a lot of bullying in school and stuff like that?
Yeah, it was pretty bad. Like people would like draw cocks in my mouth on my student council posters. And I guess they assumed that I was gay because I was a singer. I remember I was living in Manhattan and I was dating this guy.
Wait.
I was gay because I was a singer. I remember I was living in Manhattan and I was dating this guy.
Hey man, I don't think they were drawing dicks on your mouth because you were a singer. Am I missing something? What?
We just, you know, had a great meal and we held each other's hands. Right when we got out, it started to rain, and this guy takes out a switchblade and he's like, you fucking faggots, I'm gonna get you. And like we ran, and it just like showed me that there still is a lot of like triggering that can happen when two men or two women are showing love.
Right.
I mean, yeah, I definitely have same-sex attraction, and it's interesting, when I do things like detox from glyphosate and atrazine, I start to feel an increase in a procreative urge. The testes tingle around beautiful women.
Listen, first off, the bullying he went through is not cool. Sure, fine. Okay, we can all... That's not even a hot take. I'm so confused why this guy is maintaining that he is not gay in any way, but he's like, yeah, I have sexual relations with men. I have sexual attraction to men. Dog, you're gay or bi or something. Oh, he's a singer. Okay, I'm realizing now. I'm seeing chat caught me up. He's actually a singer. Okay, he's a singer.
Before they were completely, I was cut off from them. The more I retain my seed, the more I eat well, the more I do same-sex erotic
bonding, semen retention,
the more pussy I want to eat. So that's what I'm interested in. How can we use same-sex erotic bonding, superfood nutrition, detoxification to enhance male potency so that men can feel more juicy and primal and wild? Lingam means pillar of light in Sanskrit. The cock, the ears, are really great places to massage because they've got so many nerve endings in them that relate to the entire body. So in my classes, we get naked and we literally massage our...
That was not a penis. It's a popsicle. Okay, your kids can have one. Relax.
Cocks together. And this is called penis reflexology.
This is a diagram in terms of penis reflexology. It's a little bit blurry. So basically, we massage each other's heart meridians to help release self-hatred while cuddling and watching Obi-Wan Kenobi. And it was just so beautiful. And this is what my Celtic ancestors did. They would also suck each other's nipples and share each other's beds before battle.
If you do some more digging, Spartans were actually doing same-sex erotic.
Man, I don't listen. If I was about to go get brutally killed by some arrows and some swords and get fucking stabbed and die on the field, I'd probably suck my bro's nipples too. I'd probably suck on it. I'd fucking put my dick in any open hole. Like, what's it? Okay, yeah, you're sending me to go die. Yeah, I'll take it. Who got the biggest titties on our in our troop here? I don't give a fuck. You know. Anyway.
Bonding. They believed if you ingested the semen of a big strong man, that you would become a big strong man. And they still do that in tribes that have not yet been contacted by the West. In Papua New Guinea, for example, they actually have to suck as much cock as they can before they hit the age of 20 or 21, and then they can marry a woman. Just to get as much sperm into their bodies as they can, because they believe it like...
That doesn't feel true. I don't know. I'm ignorant. That doesn't feel accurate. Lewd Kiwi! This is the greatest GTA... Or is this the latest GTA 6 leak? He does seem like a side character, doesn't he? He'd have the best side missions, bro. Holy shit.
It's got testosterone in it, too.
I really think he's lying.
Their manhood.
My testicles attract girls from all over the world.
Ladies? Anyone in chat?
My testicle attract humans from all around the world.
My balls produce massive amounts of testosterone.
My balls produce massive amounts of testosterone.
My testicles are an engine of alpha growth.
My testicles are an engine in alpha growth.
Beautiful. So for most of my life, I couldn't feel my balls. Now that I do this ritual regularly, I can actually feel the sperm being produced in my balls, and I feel so much more grounded.
I couldn't feel my cock and balls unless I was fully erect. And even when I was fully erect, I couldn't even really feel my nuts. I felt just like there was nothing there. Also, I was sexually abused by a doctor when I was four. So it was a combination of like a chemical, almost like a chemical castration plus the shaming of the abuse. So the sexual kung fu lineage has literally helped me like feel my balls again, mix the blood and the chi in my nuts. People always say, Will, can I really grow my penis? And I say, yeah, just fucking pull on it.
I witness his cock.
It's joking. It's a real thing. It seems kind of, I don't know. I'm not going to do it, but you know. I believe jelking actually has some sort of like temporary, I don't know if it's real. I had a pastor tell me about it. I'm not even lying. I'm just gonna stop talking.
Cock change for sure, like his cock's gotten bigger.
It was probably flaccid, maybe 2-3 inches. And then erect, it was maybe 5 inches. Now, it's usually about 3-4 inches flaccid, and erect, it goes to about just over 6 inches.
So many dudes that I work with and that I've chatted with, actually I'd say every dude, is worried about, is their dick gonna be perceived as small? This like fear of like, oh my God, if I show my dick. And this work has helped me to feel like I don't really care about what someone thinks of my dick. I'm just like, this is my
dick. Nice, let's go, dude.
None of you guys have super small dicks.
Thanks, man.
None of you guys, man.
The changes I've noticed in my own genitals, not just localized to that area, it's more so their interconnection to the rest of my body. If I'm engaging in sex with somebody, I'm not just focused on this little, as Will would say, a bubble of awareness in that area. It seems to have coalesced back into a full system where if I'm receiving a hug, for example.
Stop.
My whole body's involved usually, except for my genitals. I seem to be unaware of that. Even in those moments now, my full body's back.
Did This dude is a menace at like his niece's birthday party, bro. Come give Uncle Ricky a hug.
Ugh. Online, I'm not. So
you're putting question marks on me. This guy just said my dick is connected to everywhere. So now when I get hugs, I feel it everywhere. Bro, that ain't right. What do you mean? Disconnect that, bro. What do you mean? I don't want to hug Nana on Thanksgiving and nut.
Emotionally castrated from one area.
Emotionally
or not,
castrated.
A full revival of the intrinsic system.
That's fair. That's fair.
And this is great to do like in a circle.
I just realized who this guy is. This guy is all over TikTok and he drinks his pee all the time. Oh my God, I just realized this is that guy. I've seen this guy on TikTok. This dude is a fucking piss drinking monster, bro. Oh my God. Sorry, it all just hit me. He suns his asshole too. Yes, dude.
Communicate subtly through the pelvic consciousness. I call it the testiculum. Kind of like the mycelium network in the forest. Yeah. The mushroom is the cock and the mycelium are the testicles. So it's like, let them fill with this yang chi, with this yang prana, and exhale, appreciate it, right? Because gratitude is the highest form of yoga. So you're like, you're basically blessing your nuts for the upliftment of all of humanity, and you're increasing the frequency of the mini brain of your gonads by smiling and growling.
Hey guys, I'm gonna let you on a little secret that I learned from a master in Yogi Bear, okay? Chi isn't real. If you ever hear somebody say chi, the conversation's over. If you ever hear somebody say frequencies, okay, listen in. They're probably full of shit unless you're talking some, I don't know, radio bullshit, all right? They're brain, dick, chi, all that shit, not real. You hear that, you walk away, okay? It's just, I'm sorry. That should be an instant red flag. I don't care if everything else this guy said is true. You hear chi, you walk away. It's done. Or toxins? Oh my God. Oh my God. The word detox is so overused.
And you can do this when you're having sex with a woman. You can.
What about chakras?
Thrust.
I'm done.
If you're about
We're done. Don't talk about
don't
chakras.
Want to ejaculate, growl into your balls. It's so
The world's
powerful.
Not Naruto, bro.
And literally, you can feel some of the energy will leave your system and come into your body instead.
Energy too.
And she'll probably be more wet because of it, because women like to be ravished. I went to musical theater school. I was actually in Canadian Idol. I made it pretty far. They kicked me off for being too theatrical.
Oh, did they?
To fast forward throughout the last 15 years, I was teaching what we would call like hatha yoga, like stretchy stretch yoga. Mm-hmm. And it was great, but it felt like there was something missing. I
what
started
was missing?
To get into other modalities. I was like, I need more. And also I got addicted to cocaine. So I stopped doing that.
Wait, hold on. I laughed through that, but you guys need to hear this sentence. It's so funny.
Great, but it felt like there was something missing. I started to get into other modalities. I was like, I need more. And also I got addicted to cocaine. So I,
you know, it's so funny because, okay, I'm gonna dunk on this guy so fucking hard right now. All right. He is so hyper fixated on devoting his life to something that will legitimately have no effect on his body. Chakras, chi, bullshit. He's so hyper fixated on whatever minute to nothing effects these things can have on you while being addicted to a substance that fucking burns holes in your nose and brain and can fucking permanently and measurably destroy you. It's just so funny to me how it's like, oh, the chi and the chi, my dick is a noodle that sucks into the earth with vines. It's like, you're so focused on this shit while being addicted to cocaine, bro. What is, it's so dumb. The biggest change you could, like, just don't, stop doing cocaine. Noodle dick, full penis system, and New York Coke, that's right. How's your nose holes after TwitchCon? Good!
I stopped doing that, and I started to look for other ways to get high. Drinking my piss gets me kind of high. I don't know how it
Oh my
works.
God.
Doing breath work.
I hyperventilate myself. Yeah, no shit. I'll thank all the subs after this, guys. I appreciate it. Bro,
inhale.
He's hyperventilating.
Suspend the breath. Squeeze the anus, sex organ, navel. Shunt the energy up your spine into your pineal.
Oh, you're so full of beans, you fucking loser.
Exhale, keep
loser.
The energy in your body, round forward, suck your abs in, shunting all this creative energy into the rest of your system.
He's literally an addict.
Inhale. High on your own supply, baby.
Cash App. The easy way to pay a male yogi to take you into the forest for an afternoon of platonic male bonding rituals. You can also use Cash App to buy, sell, and send Bitcoin instantly. But it gets even
better.
Andrew,
I feel assaulted by this ad.
If you go to the App Store or to Google Play and download Cash App right now, you can use code CHANNEL5 to get a free 15 bucks for new users.
Free 15?
Terms apply. Cash App. It rules.
For me, rewilding is reconnecting to Mother Earth. A lot of yogic lineages that are really popular these days, like Kundalini, is all about connecting to the third eye and to heaven and to other dimensions. But the thing I love about rewilding and sex kung fu, it's about connecting to your balls, your cock, your tribe, and Mother Earth. It's about coming back into that wild state. Instead of being a chihuahua, coming back into that wild wolf state.
This is your body. There's no reason for us to not have access to being free at all times within reason. I think the apprehension that people have in wanting to create a set of rules around that is that so many people have unhealthy associations to their sexuality that they are a danger, hence creating these strong boundaries in society. In order to get to a place where you can free the nipple and free the rectum completely, you also have to look at, yeah, the shadowy, shitty part of people that would want to take advantage of that or are only doing it as this means of getting away with something. You know, I want to show my genitals to people because there's something unresolved there, as opposed to these are my genitals, this is fucking it, no big deal.
Semen retention.
Here it
so
is.
That doesn't mean you never ejaculate. It means that you increase the time between ejaculating.
Okay, hold on. Everyone's telling me 1645 has a dick. I'm going to check that on my own right now just to see, because a dick would be pretty bad. I'm at 1645. Hold on, boys.
Some camaraderie.
Yeah. It absolutely has a penis. It absolutely has a penis. Okay, it absolutely has a penis. No, it's not censored. I can identify exactly what this man's genitals look like. If this man was in a lineup, I could point him out. So we will be skipping 1640. Oh my god, it's about to become a minefield in this video. These last couple minutes are really... Did Hassan show that part? Boy, I hope not, because there was a full penis. Is it big? Let me look again. Hold on, just give me a second. I want to look again. Hold on.
I believe there'd be a lot more peace and camaraderie.
Yeah. I would say this guy has a pretty normal, soft penis from what I can see here. I will say this, though. It looks like it's been tugged on. Like, I don't know how to describe it. I would say it's a pretty good size flaccid, but I know this guy's been pulling on it. So maybe, I'm gonna be honest, okay? Some of y'all fluffing, and I would say this guy definitely has fluffed a little. I don't think there's anything. He's got a pretty normal penis, all things considered. Looks a little fluffed. But more importantly, it looks like it's been pulled on, bro. It looks like it's been, you know, through a dishwasher a couple times. Well, anyway, where were we?
I mean, if we think about it, a whole new baby can be created from an ejaculation.
What?
So if we're just constantly ejaculating, we're kind of wasting our life force. So I teach them how to separate orgasm from ejaculation. So then they can choose when they want to come, ejaculate, or shunt that energy upwards.
So when's the last time that you ejaculated?
Last night.
What?
Yeah, I can actually show you. This is pretty intense. So me and my buddy Brian did a new moon ejaculation ritual.
For those who are wondering what you're missing right now, it's a man holding some sort of printer paper, 8x11 or whatever it is. And it is just covered in dried cum. And he's handling it very carelessly.
Wrote what we wanted to let go of, and we ejaculated onto it.
They wrote on the paper, it says, releasing... purging, shame, caring what others think, overthinking, pressure, something, and it's just a paper covered in cum. And what's gross too about it, my cum does not last around me. I didn't realize cum darkens and almost looks like a maybe like a dirty stain, coffee stain almost.
It was actually very powerful. And then we...
Oh, there's a pube on there. There is a stray pube that is fused to the paper.
Let it dry. That's his.
Oh my God, I'm gonna vomit.
This is a bit more intense.
The second page he just turned to is so fucking yellow. And he even says this one's a bit more intense.
His is a bit more intense.
With the recent ejaculation ceremony we did, my intention was to purge certain energies or certain narratives. Then we do some sex kung fu, so testicular breathing, and then we draw up some of that energy as we're stimulating ourselves.
Wait, where was the penis again? What was the timestamp for the penis?
As we're exciting ourselves, so that all the sexual energy doesn't get poured out of the ejaculate.
Thank you.
And then eventually we bring ourselves to full ejaculation. And then later we'll burn that paper.
So we're letting go of shame, caring about what other people think, overthinking. I think my comfort zone is shame. So leaving the comfort zone is coming to joy. But it's like, do I deserve to feel so good and so juicy? Because I felt so bad for so long.
And what I really want to say is that gay panic has been brainwashed into all of our psyches because these types of activities release...
Bro, you're doing gay activities, though. There's a fair point to be made about this gay panic you're referencing, but you're fucking dudes and dating men. Like, what do you need? What more is being gay than being... What else is there?
High amounts of testosterone. They lower competition and comparison. It's a sense of de-armoring. You know, there's far too much competition between men.
I'm sorry.
And if
this
world's
whole minute,
male
penis!
Leaders did this
there's
work together, I believe there'd be a lot more peace and camaraderie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, he's playing the piano. Oh, I almost just cut back to show you him playing the piano, but it cuts to a close-up of the very, very yellow cum paper. My God. It's just piano and cum paper, boys. Piano and cum paper.
Heard there was a secret chord David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care. Kitchen chair, she broke your throne, cut your hair from your lips, she drew the hallelujah. It's not a cry that you hear at night. Oh, it's not someone who claims
coming up
to have seen the light. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. Sing with me.
Bare ass is about to be on screen. He is a good singer.
Everybody sing with me.
This is his thing? I guess it is. I don't know. He's not naked on stage. He's wearing a onesie. He's not naked. He knows one song. All right. I think we end it there. Oh, there he stands up. He gives a hug. What's Andrew have to say about it?
Live show in Toronto about 3 weeks ago. Oh, yeah. If you guys didn't know, we're going on a 43-city national
Holy
Channel 5
shit.
Live tour. Milwaukee, Madison, Phoenix, Denver, Philly, New York, Hamden, Connecticut, New Haven, Connecticut. Yeah. Milwaukee.
Where am I from? San Luis Obispo. Ew. San Francisco. Ugh. Fresno, ugh! Sacramento! What are these dog shit? Los Angeles and San Diego, let's go! Let's go! Saved! And it's in December. Oh, the last one. He's ending in SD, baby? Oh, what a good way to end, my brother. We should go, dude. All of California. Ugh. Okay, dude. Okay, dude. Yo, if your city or a city near you is on this list, go crazy in chat. Go stupid. He hit him. You know what? I was going to be so mad that he was all... Look at all these shitty California cities. And then he saved it. With he, you know, he saved the best for last. Eugene, Oregon. Ugh. Ugh. They out there popping out dog shit humans. Portland. Ugh. Ugh. Keep Portland weird. Shut up. Ugh. Seattle. Ugh. I'm kidding. I'm sorry. Portland is actually fun. Word of the day. All right. Well then, so now that I've secured my ban, now that I've guaranteed I will not make it to Friday's stream, we might as well just never go offline. Let me thank all those subs that came in, by the way. I appreciate you guys. Daddy Butter, thank you for the five. Friendly Faraga, thank you for the five. Daddy Butter again, thank you. CM Buzzkill, thank you for the 10, brother. Swin Diesel, thank you. Appreciate you for the 10. Moist Waffle, thank you. Childhood Trauma. Shit's crazy. Kelly, thank you guys both. Chelsea, thank you again. All right, cool. Do a subathon right now, I dare you. I can't. I can't. My mom is actually going to be dead that day. I'm sorry. Cheap. Oh, I'm sorry.
I fell.
Oh, man. She's actually going to... Yeah, I know. Don't care. What's wrong with you? Criss Angel. Wubby, oh, seven, dude. Wubby, seven, Wubby, are we okay? Wubby, do we seven, Wubby, Alluux? Wubby, Alluux. Seven. Okay, here's what I'm gonna do. Alluux, we're doing Wubby, cringe. You cringe. You drink Wubby, at 7:30. Okay. Wubby, so you play Wubby, games. Wubby, you have fun. Wubby, you do what you gotta do, Alluux. 7:30. We'll do cringe. You drink. Okay. Didn't you want to do a subathon this year? I said I'm gonna do a subathon. And then I retire.
Bungus.
Jump into the Criss Angel hole. Crazy. Check the sub count. We're so close. I'll check the subreddit though. Let's see what the Reddit's been saying about all this. For those who wanted to see it, here's the accidental penis. Was I wrong? Ew, dude, it's actually pretty gross. His dick looks like it, I don't know. It just looks swollen. Butt. I don't know. It don't look right.
Can we touch butts?
No. Bro, the phone thing, did you watch it? Not yet. It's a long video. That's a lot of commitment.
Yeah, daddy.
The top of the sub right now is, I met Wubby and Alluux has made my day. I have a story about this photo that this guy did not tell. So this photo with this guy, I don't like how I look in it, but we'll move past that. What's funny is,
show me your balls, Wubby.
Directly in front of us, that's not Peanut. I don't have small eyes. Directly in front of us here, we're all waiting at the train track to get back into TwitchCon. And in front of us is CallmeCarson. And he's standing there. And this guy is in front of me, and CallmeCarson's in front of him. And I'm standing there talking to Booty, and I'm like, yeah, that's Carson. That's, like, actually Carson. And this guy is talking to his friend. He's like, I think it's Carson. And I, like, kind of loud. I'm like, yeah, that is Carson. And he turns around. He's like, oh, I knew it. And he turns around, looks back at his friends, and then he whips back, 1,000-yard stare. Are you Wubby? I'm like, I shouldn't have said anything. Eh, my fault. And then that's him. There's his little photo. So we actually got to experience Carson together. Isn't that fun? How cute is that, huh? All right. 17 and 19 is not grooming. Okay. I shouldn't have read that. Thank you for... Listen. I'm too old to experience Carson.
Love you, Wubby.
Tyler. Okay, so I'll get. Dad, are you watching? I hate doing this.
In October. Help.
Dad, are you watching? Dad, if you're watching, can you text me right now?
I have a request.
I used to be so back in the day. I don't think I've ever said this. I wanted to be a magician. Back in the day. I wanted nothing more. I think we all had a magic phase, right? What young little lad? I don't really see many lasses doing it. But I'll, you know, if my daughter wants to be a magician, you know, I'll slap her and hand her a sponge, as you do. But if my son wants to be a magician, I'll say anything, son, the world's yours. Okay, but I wanted to be a magician as a child. And a lot of that stems from the show Criss Angel Mindfreak. I remember the first magic thing I ever saw was David Blaine. You're saying tell the Criss Angel story. Bro, what are we talking about right now? You're impatient to the point of brain damage. My aunt dated him? No, she didn't. Bro, you got... Is there a cool story? I need to know. What the fuck? Too fat to fly? What does that mean? Tell the story you're currently telling. I don't have a story. Anyway, Dad. My dad picked up that I loved Criss Angel. And I remember... this is so embarrassing, dude. There was a time... Well, let me show you guys what Criss Angel looks like. Criss Angel... Mind Freak. Criss Angel is a magician who had a television show that made magic cool and edgy. And I wanted to be him. And that includes his look. And for those wondering, this was his look. This was the look when he was at his peak, bro. This was like Criss Angel Mind Freak show. He was so cool. He had the handcuff down to the crucifix with the A for Criss Angel. Karen hair. Wow. That was Karen hair. Before Karen hair. Oh my God, bro. Criss Bagel. What? What is that supposed to mean? My dad would get me all these Criss Angel shirts and I thought it was so cool and I always wanted to see him and meet him. Anyway, today Charlie Critical put out a video about Criss Angel and it got me going. And it got me watching all these old fucking tricks he used to do. And if anybody has a favorite one they want to send me, we can watch it. But I just... David Blaine shopping at Hot Topic. Dude, he really was cringe. This isn't my favorite or anything, but this is one of the first ones that came up. And I just... It is... It's such a great introduction to how absurd this show was at the time, and I can't believe I really must have been so annoying and stupid. I can't believe this show took over America. I did meet Criss Angel. It was weird though. It was awkward. Because this show is so clearly so fake and so acted and so weird. And I'm gonna show you this little clip here. Grand Canyon. No, I met Criss Angel at Planet Hollywood. Recently, when I was there recently, and I was standing there waiting for my Uber, and this small man comes running in, and I hold the door for him, and he's kind of trying to hide and keep it down the down low, and he walks in. I'm like, "You're Criss Angel," and he goes, "Shh," and then he runs by me. That's it. He was wearing a wig, and then I turned to Pete. I'm like, "That's Criss Angel." Anyway, watch the Grand Canyon trick. Oh, okay. Let me show you this one, then we'll watch it. By the way, get ready for the lowest quality. Okay. People who have glasses, just take them off. It'll blend the pixels together. There's one part of this video that it's just... We're going to talk about it. Okay, here we go.
I've proven that a solid can pass through a solid.
Before we start, hold on. I'm going to assume you guys haven't seen Mindfreak, which is his show. Okay, I'm going to assume that. But you will realize very quickly, the man is... probably the worst type of magician. He is the type of magician who I can't stand, right? There's like David Blaine who does like these insane cool things but still recognizes that some of them are magic, some of them are pushing your body. Criss Angel pushes the idea. He's like, "I'm a fucking wizard. I've already demonstrated to you that I can pass a solid through a solid.
I've proven that a solid can pass through a solid. I've demonstrated it literally when I passed through a storefront window." Now watch, hit it. Really, oh check it out. As I pass through a taxi cab.
Go.
A metal door.
This is my favorite one. This one clip, I was like, I have to show this to Chad. This is so absurd.
Take it away.
Oh my God.
But a metal gate.
Bro, everyone's watching this like, oh, what? He almost, what? He got caught.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Bro, with his face fucking smushed. 11-year-old me was, dude, me too. No, when I was a kid, I was like, oh, he got stuck with a beard. Oh my God, what happened? I remember this exact, me too. But I'm realizing now, okay, this is where it gets really embarrassing. This is not a lie. I forced my father and my mother, who were divorced, to sit down together with me to watch this show. And I'm realizing now, back then, I thought we were all fans. I now sit here, my father, who is older than I am now at the time, obviously, okay, had to sit there as an intelligent adult and bear with this shit. I made him look at this and watch me as I freaked out. What year did this air? We could do an actual age on me. You're the reason they got divorced? I've come to terms with that. And you know what? The reason, too, is probably because I was a fat kid, you know? My parents probably got divorced because I was overweight. If I had to guess, I mean, I've thought about everything. I've thought about this for 20 years. If I had to guess, it's probably because I was an overweight child. And stupid. By the way, this aired yesterday. Hey, good one, chat. You're funny.
I'm stuck in the door! Has its own set of challenges.
What's your name? I'm Messi.
Messi. Are you really?
Some days.
God, he really, it's crazy. This is what I mean, guys. Never be stylish. Do not dress noteworthy. You know why? In 20 years, you will be the poster boy for what current cringe is. Look at how he dressed here. This is literally how m'ladies dress now. Like, it's so, he's wearing a leather or, I don't know, some sort of shiny material button up, a fedora, torn jeans. This guy was so fucking hot back in the day, dude. I'm not even lying. Never, ever, ever dress like this. Just be normal and be boring, because in 20 years, be like, oh, it's still boring. Bikini Barbie with the 100! Just in time, bro! We're about to watch the Criss Angel freak our fucking minds. I watched this already, but I think I saw something kind of sussy baka with it, and I want you guys to help me figure it out, okay? Thank you, Bikini Barbie.
Have we ever met before, honestly?
Never.
Liar. All right. Liar, they probably all
met. I've seen you on TV, but I've never met you in person.
Do I look the same?
Awesome. Yep.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
You're attracted to me, huh?
Someday.
All right, what do I want you to do?
God, it's so cringe, bro!
Messies, I want you to examine. We have a gate here. I want you to check out, examine okay. It for me. Right. Make sure it is solid. Iron, fair. Is that true? Is that sure. Fair? Yep. Solid?
Yep.
Cool. I also want to show the inside so that everybody at home realizes that there's no one hidden inside. As a matter of fact, take a look. Mike, you want to get in there and just take a look at that? Go ahead.
Okay, pay attention to what bars he pulled on to validate the metal gate.
There's no one hidden in there. You have a nice, huge trash can there. We lock it because a lot of people always empty their trash.
Whoa,
in my
ladies,
can, and I
ladies.
Have to pay for it, so I'm sick and tired of the bull. So now this kind of avoids that.
He kind of went on a little miniature tangent there. We actually put this metal door here because I'm sick and tired of these fucking homeless people digging through our trash, and now with this gate here, these fucking bums who honestly should be gathered up and killed in this fucking shithole city, this gate's gonna prevent the fucking homeless people. We're like, hey, Criss, like, we know the purpose of gates. I'm actually fully aware of how gates function.
Pay for it, so I'm sick and tired of the bull. So now this kind of avoids here. That. Thank you very much. We're gonna close
my
this
audio's
up.
Lagging?
And Messi, would you be so kind to literally lock me in here?
He was just quoting a song for me.
You got that?
I got it.
Good, lock it. Check the lock. Is that fair?
Fair enough.
Fine. I will now stay here for 30
cardboard
days.
Just pick it up and hold on to it. Now, there's only really one way out, and that would be if I climbed over the wall or the fence. Or, of course, there's another.
When I was a kid, dude, you are a 3-month sub, and you're just now putting your first time chatter. You're a 3-month sub. All right, young Joseph said, when I was a kid, I used to have to hide the fact that I watched Criss Angel from my mom. She's seen the episode where he walks on water and told me he was the Antichrist. Are you by any chance like Hispanic? I just feel like I can hear that conversation in Spanglish better than I can in English.
Another way. Let me show you what I'm gonna do. Messi, hold on to that for a second. I asked you before, I'm gonna need that, but first I'm gonna take my foot and I'm gonna place it right through the gate, just like so.
Okay, let's chat. We're gonna figure this shit out together. So real quick. There are three bars that I'm aware of that are horizontal that would make this extremely challenging. The vertical ones could bend and move and then he could just slip through, in theory. The three bars that would make this difficult are this bar at the top, look at my mouse, this bar right here, and this bar down here, okay?
Watch. Let me have that.
I feel like I'm art. See, this is what I maybe I'm getting like pixel skipping here. The second bar from the bottom, this one right here, I feel like it already starts jiggling. Oh, what, dude? I'm getting bot raided. With followers right now. Look at this shit. Dude, I don't think I've ever seen this happen. Look at this. Look at how many. Look at this. No, bro, pad those numbers. You think I give a fuck? Bro, ease your sponsorships. Let's go. I don't know if I've ever gotten bot followers like this before. Can we get to 1 million, huh? Holy shit. Okay, actually, though, what do I do? What do I do, though? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Ban, I am not. This is not me. I do not encourage this. And we will be doing what we can to make this not happen. What the fuck is going on? Ban incoming. That's not how that works, but okay. I don't even know what to do. I it's not stop. I'm just looking. It's completely freezing my everything. Well, just roll with it. And we'll use Commander Root later. Is that a thing? I feel like I finally made it, guys. Gone up 1K so far. Man, what a slow system. All right, let's continue. All right, here's what I want to show you. Watch this bar. Watch the set. Wait. Wait. All right, fuck it. Let's watch. Here we go.
The fence, it was cast iron, nobody could get through that.
It was unbelievable.
It's all metal.
I examined the fence, it was cast iron.
Crazy.
As soon as I get home, I'm gonna tell my mom that Criss Angel just passed his whole body through a solid door. It's gonna be, she's not gonna believe it. Magic is not real to me, but seeing that up close and personal was amazing.
Can solid pass through solid? Absolutely.
We're arguing again. Come on, what did you just say to me? Go ahead, tell the camera what.
I asked my son really to tell me how he did it, because I really don't know, and I want to know how he did it. How did you do that? I mean, seriously, I'm your mom. You can tell me everything. You know that. So you're going to tell me now?
I'm not going to tell you now on the air, Mom. Come on.
Oh, it's so painful. Wubby's mom? How is that my mom? All right, give me another one. We have 13 minutes to kill. Oh, wait, there's an explanation for it? Yo, there's an explanation video! Oh my God, there's an explanation video. Fuck, you were watching that. Dude, look at this. Is it really that easy? Okay, here we go. Yeah. 15 minutes. Oh my God.
His real name is Christopher Nicholas, but we know him as Criss Angel, an American Greek magician who is brilliant in staging his tricks.
Was that just a fucking dead bird? Hey, watch this trick. See how there's life? See how there's a blood force in this bird? Watch what happens with this hammer.
And today, we're going to unlock the secrets behind his most complex magic tricks. Let's begin.
I gotta say, this dude's accent is kind of fire, though. Or life force, blood pumping, sorry.
Trick number one, the invisible angel. This trick is peculiar and mind-boggling. At first, the magician
jumped to the correct trip, but don't you want to know how he does this one?
She stands above a simple handmade stage, then asks his assistants to raise the curtain until it conceals
him completely. I'm invested!
After seconds, the assistants take the curtain down, but there is no sign of the magician.
Where'd Criss
go? He vanished in the thin air, so where did he go?
Where did
Criss go? In the beginning of the trick, you can see that every person has a shadow, including the man in the back in phosphoric t-shirt and the barrel next to him. Moments after, the camera angle was changed a little bit, and when it came back to the same scene, a trained eye would observe some differences. First of all, you can see that the shadow of the man in the back and the barrel next to him shrank and moved back. The reason of that and the secret of the trick is because the magician used a mirror and placed it in this exact area. As the mirror would definitely hide the lower body of the man in the back, the magician brought another man in the front, wearing a similar pants to appear in the mirror reflection.
Yo, no shot, dude.
It made them look like...
Hold on. So you mean to tell me that there's this guy in like the high viz standing here, but then over here behind this camera, that like our point of view, there's another dude wearing the same pants or similar pants? Bro, this is so cringe. This isn't magic.
Like one standing person. Simultaneously with removing the curtain, the magician jumped down and hid behind the mirror, making the viewer think.
You can kind of tell he's got different legs.
If you still doubt using a mirror in this trick, take a closer look.
No. When I say that, I don't mean magic isn't real. Okay, you guys are so dumb.
Look at the comparison between the shadows before and after placing the mirror. The shadow size of both the man in the back and the barrel have changed.
The barrel's even different! That's a different fucking barrel!
And the barrel color has changed too. Even the shape of the ground looks different. And
the ground is different, bro!
For the part when Criss untied the rope, clutching on his hands, two elements included. The first, the magician took more than 12 seconds talking to his assistants. During that time and giving his skills, he managed to untie the rope using his sleight of hand.
It's not
I guess that's fair. The rope to help Criss untie his hands and reconnect the rope quickly. These little mistakes have revealed the secret of this near-perfect trick.
Okay, fair. I'm not mad about that one.
Trick number two. Salt and ground pepper break up. In this trick, the magician mixes some salt and some ground.
Okay, we should skip to ours. Wait, this is the most replayed though. Okay, let's watch this one and then we'll skip to ours.
Pepper on a glass table, then takes the girl's hand and places it on the mixture. In the same time, he extends his left hand under the table, right beneath the mixture. A few seconds later, he opens that hand and surprisingly, the ground pepper is there in his palm.
Whoa, okay, come on. How do you not want to know what happens there, you bozos?
While the salt above is free of pepper. The question is, how did he manage to disassemble the mixture? And how-
Go ahead, chat. Fucking smart people. Go ahead. How do you do it? Magnets? Pepper isn't magnets!
How did the ground pepper move to his hand under the table? As a matter of fact, if we want to separate both components that are as tiny as sands, we will need hours and hours.
Hours.
But the magician
hours.
Did it in seconds.
He did
the
it
secret
in seconds.
Of this trick is as follows. Firstly, what the magician blended with salt was not actually ground pepper, but magnet powder that looks like it. And when he asked the girl to place her hand on the mixture, he secretly inserted his hand in his pants pocket and extracted another fistful of magnet powder. Here you can notice how he inserted his open empty hand and how then he extracted it tightly closed because it contained magnet powder inside. After
that, how did he get it out though?
He started circling the magnet right under the mixture. It's then a simple physics. Magnet attracts to magnet, and when it does, the magnet powder in the mixture goes down and disappears below salt, while salt goes up and appears pure and clean. And this is how he did the trick.
That's still kind of impressive, though. That's still relatively impressive. You got to admit. Okay, well, let's just find ours now. You got to admit that's still kind of like to pull it off and it look convincing. There's the dead dove. Oh my god. Where's our? Here we go through the gate. Here we go. This is some dramatic fucking intro stuff. The Grand Canyon.
Trick number seven. I'll open through it. The gate of iron bars. This trick is brilliant and truly hard to figure out. At first, the magician stands behind this gate of iron bars, brings someone to make sure it is not a fake and it is tightly closed. Criss then takes a cardboard to cover his front look. He starts moving towards the iron gate and surprisingly passes through it as if his body is made of air. So how did he perform this amazing trick? Actually, the secret of this trick is complex and all what we have is a theory.
Bro, dude, I'm so mad right now. The entire reason I clicked on this video. Actually, I do not know, and we have a theory. Bro, come on.
The facts first. The man who was examining the gate never approached the joining points of the bars.
True.
He only laid his hands on the side column.
And they also cut, so none of that matters anyway.
And the safety.
And also, who the fuck is this guy? So none of that matters anyway.
Look, also, if you look at the joining points of the bars, you will notice that they are thicker than usual.
And they are weird. They are kind of unusual.
He went through the gate. He seemed pushing something forward. And lastly, why was he covering himself in the process? So, based on that, I will say that the secret lies in the custom design of the gate. It has a hidden hinges in the joining points of the bars that facilitate the movement of the bar segments to the outside when pushing it from the opposite direction and go back to normal.
I don't know, my man's was an art. Look at this art, bro. It's so, I mean, it's so convincing.
After passing it through, and this is why the magician appeared like he was struggling while passing the gate. If you don't agree with this explanation, let us know your theory in the comments below.
Seems plausible, yeah. This dude's B-roll is very strange, by the way. How do we end up here? I don't know, bro. Hold on, we have one more. Grand Canyon jump? Let's watch it. Fuck it, let's just watch it.
Before I begin, I want to point out two things. I have a hearing...
Oh. My. God! The... Criss Angel, I am coming for you, you fucking hack fraud loser. I'm so... You betrayed me, Criss. You're such a fucking... I'm so mad at Criss Angel right now. Criss, seriously. I hope you eat shit and I don't want to say die because that might be too far. But you're a fucking snake oil salesman. You had the nerve to tell a loving child supporter of you that there are no... camera tricks, bro. I can count three and we're not even done. I can. Why lie? Why not say, hey, we're going to trick you here. Try to figure out at home. Here we go. Why are you? I'm actually close to crying right now. I'm so mad at this fucking snake, dude. I'm seriously gonna burn all my Criss Angel memorabilia. I'm so mad. He's dead. Good. He lied. He had lied. Criss Angel, I want you to hear my words. I am seriously, this is a very public legal threat I am making, not in jest. This is real. This is legal. Criss Angel, if I see you, I'm punching you in the face. I'm joking. I'm playing a character. I'm obviously joking. I'm joking. I play a character. I'm kidding. That character is more aggressive. You fucking hack fraud, bitch. Bitch. Criss Angel, you're a bitch. You're a hack. You're a fake, and I looked up to you! I practiced magic for you! Magic doesn't have to be real, but why are you saying there's no camera tricks? Nothing was fake in this at all. Okay, hold on. Alluux, you can come in here or not. Alluux, okay, hold on, I'm gonna call Alluux, because Alluux is waiting. She's Alluux's queen. Queen Alluux, we love Alluux. I'm gonna call Alluux right now. I'm gonna see if we can get a few more minutes, because I wanna show you guys one more. Hey, girl, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good. Are you enjoying Overwatch?
I stopped playing because I thought I was coming in there at 7:30.
You have time for another one if you want to start one. If not, you can come in.
Okay.
What do you want to do?
I'll play another one.
You play another one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. First off, you're doing great, Alluux. And I appreciate you being patient.
Mm-hmm.
Where can they find your great content?
Stop. I don't want to shout out. You just watch your videos. Just let me know so that I can
Alluux does you cringe you, Alluux does you cringe you drink live on her channel and on her Alluux highlights channel.
I do.
She does.
Okay, go back to yelling at Criss Angel for being a fraud.
Okay, bye.
Okay, bye.
Let me know when your game's over. She hung up. All right, all right, all right, all right. Now that, wait, Booty, you were saying something? You were telling me something about this? What were you telling me, Booty? I am. These are cloud cut. I can't even see the cloud cut, bro. Yeah! The cloud looks relatively the same. Yeah! God, he's such a fucking hack fraud. Yeah! Yeah! Yeah, bro, anybody can fucking boot up After Effects, you fucking bozo. That's what makes me so mad. It's like real magic, and when I say real magic, I mean like doing tricks that take skill. The point of them is that anyone can't do it, right? Any fucking Fruit Loop dingus can boot up Premiere with an hour of training and make something look convincing, bro. We get it. You know how long Penn and Teller studied sleight of hand and all this crazy shit, you hack fraud? Go get your fake pepper. Go get your fake pepper in your gate. Like, bro, this trick doesn't even make any sense, you freaking loser. What does this even mean, dude? Where does the car go? Lost to time, baby. Lost to time. The car is a victim of magic. Who cares? What? Oh, the wind was. Oh, no, no, no! No shot! No shot! They're like, and there's the car. Lost to the sands of time. God, I'm telling you guys, we were night. We gave a fucking bozo a career. We really did. America, we're all to blame. So many of you watch this shit. Right there, I see smoke. I can't. Yes, so many of you did. I'm one of them. Shit was not the cloud jumps. You can see the cloud cut. Okay, here's a clip. Now we're really getting into the pixels here. All right, let's see the clouds jump, bucko. Show me the clouds jump. Go ahead, show me.
You're a hack. You're a fake, and I looked up.
Where's the, okay? This is a little embarrassing now. I'm sorry, y'all.
You're a bitch. You're a hack. You're a fake, and I looked up to you. I practiced.
Where are the clouds jumping? Which cloud?
Bitch.
There's no way. Top left. Oh, I was looking top right.
Bitch. You're a hack.
Oh my god.
Bitch. You're a hack. You're a fake, and I looked up to you. I practiced. A bitch. You're a.
Small cut. Cam cut. Top right.
A bitch. You're a.
It's
hack.
So hard to tell. Where, Captain Disillusion? Where you at? Top right. Small cam.
A bitch.
Yep.
You're
yep,
a hack.
Yep, yep,
you're
yep.
A fake, and I looked up to you.
Oh!
My god. Dude, it's so obvious. A bitch.
Yep, okay,
you're
yep,
a hack.
Yep, yep, come
you're
on.
A fake, and I looked up
Boom!
To you.
Boom!
Oh my god. This fucking man had the nerve to call this a continuous cam.
Oh my god, Criss Angel, you are gross, dude. He still has a Vegas show.
Caught in 144p, dude.
This man has a Vegas show, bro. I should have tripped him. One more time. Look at watch my mouse. See where my mouse is? Look, just stare right there. Stare right down. Don't move.
Bitch,
stare right there.
You're a hack.
Watch.
You're a fake,
watch. Where'd
a
cloud go? Whose cloud is that? Who's fucking? I didn't know clouds move like that. What is this fucking nope? Why didn't you assault him? Man, I ask myself that every day. I don't know. This is such a great clip now, too, because just here.
Bitch!
What I'm saying while it's playing is so good.
You're a hack! You're
Where's
a fake,
it? Oh,
and I looked up
a new
to
cloud.
You. I practiced. You're a bitch! You're a hack!
Damn, I was mad that one time. All right, hold on. There's one more, and then we're done. Criss. Oh my god, I could watch these all day. Criss Angel. levitating. Okay. Now I have a bit of a story here. Where is the, is this it? No. Is David Blaine the one who did it? Criss Angel levitate on street? Hold on. Pale to Hall. Thank you, brother. Appreciate it. Where is, who did the levitation? Was it Criss? Me and my brother were trying to figure this shit out for years. Criss Angel, wait, what? You're thinking of David Blaine? Am I thinking of David Blaine? Wait, he levitated Shaquille O'Neal?
Levitated.
Stop. Stop. Hold on. Hold on. I need to go back. I need you guys to see the thumbnail. I'm crying. I'm fucking crying. This isn't real, dude. It's like a fucking, it's like a bad TikTok, bro.
Levitated.
Alluux, did you start a game? Get in here. If you haven't started a game, come on. We could do Cringe You Drink. What the fuck? What the fuck is this shit, dude? Come on, are you kidding me? Ooh, that person floating in the air. Bro, he got, hey, yo, where, hey, bro, hey, where's Shaq going? Shaq, come back! Shaq, wait. Shaq, where are you going, dude? Is that Flavor Flav? Is that Flavor Flavor? He's going over the house. Guys, I don't even know how to put this into words. This is the most surreal shit I've ever seen in my entire life. I don't even know how to speak with this on my screen, dude. What the fuck is happening? This is like a parody. And they're all just like following him. Let him down. Oh, put your fucking hands down, Criss. Like, you're doing a goddamn thing. Somewhere a crane operator is working overtime. Relax. I gotta watch it again. But I gotta watch it in 2x speed. I feel like that's just gonna be so funny. I just realized the start of this video starts with Shaq going, "Levitate me." Guys, how is this real? How is this real? He goes, yeah, he goes, say less. Whoa! Guys, is this, am I like really out of the loop? How is this not a meme? How is this not something everyone's sharing on Discord all the time? This is the most amazing shit I've ever seen in my life. It is? Oh, thank God. I'm so late on it that it's so funny. I can't. Go over the house. Yes, dude. it's actually better in 2x speed. Holy shit. Okay, I may have fucked up here, chat. I told Alluux to go play a game. And... and I only had a minute of content left, and she's not gonna be gone for a while. And it's not her fault, it's totally my fault. I'm totally the asshole. Okay, you ready to see like a really tail between legs, Wubby? Here we go. I'm gonna call her. She's in my room! Oh my god! Play cool. Alluux! No, nothing! This is perfect time! We just finished! Give it up.
Why
for...
Why are you guilty?
I'm not guilty. Okay. Did you see Shaq flying?
Yeah, I saw him as I was getting up.
Dude, absurd. Show chat my new drip. My new pump covers. Look at this, huh? Look at that. That's a little sexual, actually. That one maybe don't show. Criss Angel brought his show to my town several years ago, and he wasn't even there. His appearance was pre-recorded.
Stop.
Wow.
Charged for tickets?
I don't know if he necessarily charged for tickets. I don't know. Dude, Shaq flying around was absurd. We'll show chat in a second here. This is, hi, senor! Did I charge the mics, Alluux?
Did I charge?
The answer is yes.
Why are you asking me?
The answer may surprise you. It's yes. Guys, we're going to do, we got to do a Criss Angel night.
What does that mean?
I don't know, but I don't want to stop watching Criss Angel.
Oh.
Because it's, did you ever watch Criss Angel?
I did.
Do you know the theme song? Here, take this.
Mindfreak?
Yeah, sing it.
I don't know.
Hold on, let me get your mic on real quick.
I'd have to hear it.
Here, I'll start you off.
No, fuck, how's it go?
I am a mind freak, mind freak. There's no reality, just this world of illusion, and lying to chubby kids who look up to me. I'm a hack fraud, and I almost said a gamer word right now. I almost called him something that's only reserved for CS lobbies. But either way, I really hope he loses all his success.
It's okay.
No, it's not. Dude, it's okay. I'm
Do you want to hug?
I'm serious.
I feel like you're hurt.
I'm, no, but like, seriously though, I am a little hurt by it. I actually cannot believe how
obvious.
Yeah, how like how confident. Like, this dude was like legitimately prime time tell. Like, he was huge. Like, no lie, he was massive. And he had the balls.
Like, I'm getting him and the other guy mixed up. Did he do the ice or the other guy?
David Blaine did. David Blaine is actually like seriously talented.
Then maybe
Blaine has gone from like doing street magic and stuff and tricks to like actually pushing his body to crazy things. I think David Blaine is more of an illusionist, or I don't know if that's what you call it. Yeah. Whatever you call it. David Blaine is anyway. I like David Blaine because David Blaine too is like real with people. Yeah. I mean, I don't know. Maybe someone's gonna be like, "Well, David Blaine touched my niece." I don't give a fuck. Okay, I'm just saying, as like artists that I watch, David Blaine does not piss me off.
Yeah.
He does shit. He does like performance art. Exactly.
This is awful.
Anyway, I am a little hurt.
That's why I was gonna give you a hug, but now you don't.
No, I don't
do
think.
Do you want it?
I don't think that's gonna fill the hole.
Just try.
He didn't even listen. He, Alluux.
Hello, test.
Hi.
Did you? He fucking levitated Shaq over a house, bro.
I thought you just muted to tell me that. I thought you were like really upset. You're like, I need to mute. I need to tell you how upset I am.
Take the poster down. I hope you know I took all your. How can you just go? How can you lie like that?
Lie.
No, but really though, mm-hmm. You know, it'd be like if I one day everyone found out that I wasn't funny. No, but you want to know what it would actually be like though? Real talk.
What?
It'd be like if everyone found out that the stream is, like, scripted to the point where, like, I'm reading every word off of a doc. People would be like, and then they find out somebody else wrote it.
Bro, that's like Storage Wars.
Alluux.
Listen, I didn't know it was scripted when I was young. I thought all that shit was real. I was like, yeah. And then they're like, that's scripted. I'm like,
Alluux.
I'm like, what do you mean scripted? I'm like,
Wars?
What do you mean?
Yep. Storage Wars is not really.
Yes.
Okay, you know what?
Why am I can't be upset about my thing. Fuck you. Fuck you.
Can I apologize?
Mind Freak is a show, you know. Maybe you should just assume it's scripted. Maybe he's a stupid idiot.
That's fine. Get it out. You're right. You're valid in feeling that way. I probably am not in a position to talk where up until maybe 5 minutes ago, I thought Shaq levitated over a Hollywood Hills mansion, you know? So you're right. You're valid. I'm sorry.
There you go.
This is every day I learn a little more that I'm easy on myself and hard on others, right? But others are like me. So I need to be hard on myself and easy on others.
Or just
stupid, 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 stupid.
Peter just said, you're hard.
Okay, That was really, that was so autistic.
I was.
Wiggle Staff, thank you for the five. That was a joke, by the way, Chad. I'm not actually hitting myself. What's your favorite dinosaur?
You have to tell them that that was a joke.
Ankylosaurus or Stegosaurus. I don't know. What do you mean? Okay. You cringe, you drink. You cringe.
Who's your favorite dinosaur?
I like a lot of dinosaurs. I like the Ankylosaurus. I don't know how to say these because I just play Ark. Mm. I like Triceratops. I like plesiosauruses.
Okay.
Those are the fish ones. I like Quetzalcoatls or whatever. Those are, I don't know how to say them.
Mine is probably Littlefoot.
Littlefoot.
Or Ducky. Do you remember the
Ducky
scene?
Ducky goes. You're naming famous dinosaurs.
Listen,
though.
Listen. Do you remember the scene where Spike finally speaks and he goes, "Ducky," when she's like falling? I watched that.
Wait,
shit
Spike
so many
doesn't
times.
Speak?
No, he doesn't speak.
Well, that's his first.
And then his first thing was Ducky. You see, bro,
why
right?
That made me
iconic.
Cry.
It made me cry. I don't. And he was trying to say,
but he's just.
And he's
first
like,
time.
Ducky, yeah. And it was his first before he tried to. Don't be upset.
And wait, what?
I watched it over and over as a kid. I would just rewind and watch it and rewind. Just put Spike says Ducky. Oh my God, you're gonna make me. He goes, Ducky! My friend.
What's all this?
I don't know.
Bend down!
Why is it so long? Soup's up apart.
You got her, Dill!
Oh, here, that was it.
Then she's mine! Ducky!
Wake up! Look out!
No!
Ducky!
Why is the show sad though? I know.
Wait a minute. Is Ducky one of those fucking plesia? What is it called? Pachy? No, what is it called?
She got no teeth. I don't know.
What is the name of it?
It's, why am I crying?
You always tame one.
Oh, I don't know. I'm not sure.
Pachy? No. Mm-hmm. It's a. Yeah, parasaur. They're parasaurs.
Oh, like the ones I
the
always
The ones you
get
always tame
always...
they die. I fucking hate parasaurs. I'm like, give them my meat! Give them my hide!
I keep them in my Ark house and I pet them and feed
them.
Why
don't you ever name them Ducky then? That's what this is.
I didn't really. She's so little.
Well, she. Yeah, they grow.
Yeah. I don't know. I was named them after Pokemon.
The voice actor got murdered by her.
No, wait, in real life.
I know.
That's why are you laughing?
Because it's so. You know, where was Spike then? Yeah. That's actually really sad.
Also, I never realized he had teeth, and that freaked me out.
Yeah, there was a few aspects of this that that actually really freaked me out. There were a few aspects of it.
Oh, my God.
For example, he didn't sound as cute as it. It was, you were like, and then he goes, Ducky! And I started crying, and then he actually spoke like, yo, Spike may not have been talking, but he was smoking, all right?
He God was not damn. Okay.
Ducky! What movie is this? What movie is this, chat? Someone's gotta know.
Like the.
Like the what?
Meepers?
The what?
The meepers? The
We talked about it on stream.
The yip yips? Oh, Mars Attacks.
All right, you cringe, you drink.
Gotta do the camera.
Oh not that. This is what we've been looking. I don't adjust the camera, adjust the us.
You normally make it smaller.
You're right.
Yeah.
But you gotta go to the other side.
Yeah, you gotta put me.
Three, two.
Oh,
you
man.
Cringe your drink, but it's two Alluxes.
Yes.
Is that a man?
That is.
What are you sipping on here?
Ugly. Is my arm cut off?
You cringe your drink, chat. Wait, let's get a score going.
Let me just fix this real quick. Yep.
I was just gonna ask Booty for a drink. Spend all your time waiting. We're gonna have to figure out what I'm streaming the next two streams, or maybe I'll get. Do you think I'm gonna get banned? Honestly, that's a fair chance.
I don't know. Honestly, probably not.
Knowing you. Oh, there's two Alluxes. All right, here we go. Cringe you drink. Whatever. Some of these videos people may not find cringe. Some are funny and satire. Mm. Please do not send hate to any of the people in these videos. I'll read that every time. You know? Sometimes I fart in my dad's ass. Some. Everything lives one away. That person have Down syndrome?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Nothing cringe about that then.
No.
Someone just sit down for the count. This isn't laugh you lose, Alluux.
Kitana win. What is that? Oh, that's a foot.
Remember we're talking about fat foot? Yeah.
Whoa. Oops, I did it again.
Don't do it.
I'm turning this shit down, dude.
What was that?
Oh, wait, we should just start by drinking.
Yeah.
Cheers. God!
Was it good?
Yep, it's great.
Sounded good.
Well, we saw you cringe.
Well, he drank, so.
Okay, well, then that counts for that, right?
Yeah.
First stream? This is your first stream? Show us your balls! Take off your pants!
Do it. Know you bad when you
can post from any angle. He looks like a meatball.
Where is his nip? Oh, there it is.
Hey, bro, you got a phone call.
I hate this kind of humor. My life be like, keep it up and down. I need a sip.
I like that one.
Probably 14. Oh, I'm cringing. Oh my God, I'm cringing. Oh my God. What are we even counting? Dude, I don't know. I don't even know why there's a counter. I don't even know.
There shouldn't be
I think
a counter.
We, there shouldn't really be a counter? Counter? Really?
We've what never we... done it with a counter.
Really?
Have we?
I don't know.
I think we just kind of drink this and watch with everyone.
Yeah, I think we just drink.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow, I'm feeling already it.
Camera, action.
It's in your mouth. Oh, to get on here, you big goofy motherfucker, and call my goddamn grandson a punk, but I'm here to tell you, motherfucker, that goddamn punk my grandson.
Give me that neck.
Why was he so pink? Kiss and bite it.
Let me bite that neck.
Oh my God, I hate that. Is this the same girl? Stop. Leave this poor girl alone.
She's doing this to herself, bro.
Going. If you love and Miss Eddie.
Are they talking about Eddie from Stranger Things?
I was thinking Miss Eddie, like a teacher. I was like, Miss Eddie, love and Miss Eddie. What does that mean? But I
holy shit, what are you sipping on, bro?
Don't know.
Holy shit. Yeah, this person is heavily invested in like all the Minecraft YouTubers. For sure.
So
oh my God, she's actually getting emotional and filming herself.
Look at them brows.
Those are fake.
I know.
Oh, okay.
That jaw.
what's my school stereotype?
Oh, okay.
Thought I was a woman?
Yep.
Do love my memes.
Okay, when this guy logs on to Discord for the day, I guarantee in general chat he says, "Hello, kittens." Guarantee.
Once you get to know me and understand that I have a messed up sense of humor because of trauma, I am a funny guy.
My brother is just going for it.
Signing off.
He signs off!
What is what?
I wanna make your heartbeat run like roller coaster.
I wanna be a good girl, wanna be a gangster.
I can't get through a single video without sipping. I'm struggling.
Bro, I told you sometimes.
This is hitting different today.
Mm-hmm. Cause you could be the beauty and I could be the monster.
It's about damn time.
In a minute, I'ma need a sentimental man or woman to pump me up. Feeling fussy, walking in my Balenciennes, trying to bring out the fabulous. Cause I give a fuck way too much. I'ma need like two shots.
Okay, I'm not mad.
I'm not mad.
Is this the same girl?
No, it's a different.
Oh, okay. She's actually moving. Older. She kind of moving, too.
Yeah. Created a dance.
I'm not mad about it.
Not mad at it. Oh. Woman. Oh, okay.
Go ahead, gender this person. I'm gonna tell you right now, if you have a backpack on, there should be no ass shaking. I don't even want to see movement. Yep. In fact, if you're wearing a backpack, if you're not seated, I don't even want to be near you.
I like light skins. What a dark skin.
Grandpa fucking dying. Man, don't meme on me if I'm ever in the hospital. No. Just let me fucking die,
what
dude.
If, what if it'll get a lot of views?
I've always said, use my death to make as much money as possible. Well, so then, that's fair. Actually, quote me on that.
I just need that in a video form. That's all. He's melting. Is he saying what?
Wild and crazy arcs guy poop. Is this user? Those things are fucking schmoving, bro!
Her name is also about poop.
Why is it not working? It's not working! Just work, bro!
Bitch, go dick all in your stomach. Dick all in your stomach. Pull your hair, slap your ass, bitch.
Stop, bro. Alright.
Died after being shot Thursday evening. Officers responding to a shooting call at a home on East Main Street found the victim inside with a gunshot.
Stop moving your eyes if you're dead. The fuck?
She just casually looking around. She looking around.
How she think dead bodies work? I can't.
They were taken to the hospital and pronounced dead.
420 badass, stop.
Loving and fighting.
Nah, WTF, bro. I'm just trying to.
Nah, is that a kid? Nah. You look 18? No! Dude, what did I tell? Chat, what did I just teach you? Repeat, say it with me. If she's wearing a backpack,
get away from me.
Bro, you should never be saying she looks 18. That those words should never even leave your mouth. They're gonna clip me saying it. But. Why did you gasp?
What is happening here?
What do you mean? It's pretty clear, isn't it?
Vote for me, President of the United States.
Yeah, it's my vote.
Peterson.
Okay.
Right.
No.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Oh, that eye is getting away from him.
This everything is getting away from him.
His face is going in like four different directions. This doesn't make me cringe, though.
No.
You've got a good sense of humor.
Reese Pieces or them Lifesaver gummies?
No.
No! No!
I can't believe we're back here.
I don't want to watch this video ever again.
Alluux, I'm pretty sure on the last Cringe You Drink, we both agreed this is the worst video we've ever seen.
Yes.
And it is back.
I don't want to see it again.
I can't believe it.
It's so gross. That's way too long. No. Barbie's got a gun with no safety on.
No. The one that goes in her mouth.
And she's not talking. It's just gone. Barbie thinks it's in her mouth.
I do love that we got to share that with everybody again.
Oh God, I don't.
Wait, what is it? I'm sorry. Friday Night Funkin' or Black History
Month? Friday Night what? Why are you asking me? Answer the
question. Favorite candy? Reese Pieces or them Lifesaver gummies? If you give me a bag of them, they're gone. Boom, boom, clap, get your ass slapped. Put your hands on me, you gon' get your ass wrapped. Everything I'm saying, all facts, no cap.
Is that Popeye?
I think that's the same thing. Cindy Lou Who.
What is that hair?
The more I look at it, the worse it's
getting. I know.
Kill my mom. What the fuck? I wanna kill my dad. I wanna kill my grandma.
Is this real? Did he really just wave like that? This is how Dahmer's form, dude. This right here. Is that real?
Me and my niggas go. Dickhead. Me and my niggas, they blow like a trumpet.
I
see it. I would no go. I'm a slump shit.
She throwing it back. Did he have balls? I'm not even gonna touch that one. Murder on my mind. Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Oh, shit. I think that the audio got copyrighted.
Yeah.
Hey, yeehaw, yeah, brother!
Oh, look at him go.
He's actually schmoovin'.
He's so fluid.
He really is. Like a noodle.
He's really noodly.
God damn. I don't see anything cringier. That does remind me of that video of that old... You seen the video of the guy who poops on a...
I haven't watched many videos of people pooping, but wait, sorry, continue.
Walter, I'm sexist.
Walter, I'm sexist. there's this guy who poops on a little piece of bread in his kitchen and he eats it.
What are you, you're, why, what do you watch on the internet? Look at the question marks.
It doesn't end there, too. It gets worse.
No, but just, has anybody seen this? Anybody else watching poop on a bread and then eat it? Look at the chat. Nobody. Ain't nobody watching poop on a toast and eating it.
It wasn't toast. It wasn't cooked.
Do not let this man land.
Dude, Amanda used to fucking send it to us.
What do you mean? I've never seen it. What,
you missed that?
Well, that's also because whenever anyone sends shit, I'm like, I'm not gonna watch that.
He just plays like a... And he eats
Ryder is the only one in chat spamming, I know what you're talking about.
And then we found out that this guy, it's all of his content. He, like, has his own site, and he, like, there's a
video... Have
you seen it? There's a video? There's a video of him... You know General Sam's podcast, Forehead Fables?
Never heard of him. Who's that?
Okay, me either. They tweeted out a video of this same guy standing in his backyard, naked, shitting into his hand, and then rubbing it all on his face. They tweeted it out off their fucking official podcast thing. And everyone was like, what the fuck? Same guy.
Did they delete it?
No. And that guy, poops on a little piece of bread and eats it. He's crazy. Anyway, this guy kind of looks like him.
I hate that.
Sorry, I distracted. Oh, wait, this is the last one, I think. Okay. All right. First video out of the way. How drunk are you? How are you feeling right now?
I'm good.
You're
I'm good.
You feeling a little tipsy? We'll do a temp check after each video.
Okay. I'm feeling like a 2.
Like a 2?
Like a 2.
Out of what?
Out of like 10.
Okay.
What are you?
His name's Naked Martin, by the way.
What kind of number are you feeling?
I'm feeling probably a 2 or 3. Big Panjiggy Bones! Thank you, bro. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Hear every.
In this videos, our only entertainment.
Hear every in this videos.
Our only entertainment and comedic purposes.
Amen to that, huh? I can get behind that comfortably.
Wow.
What the fuck is this? I don't know, bitch. Is there just nudes on my... I mean,
No, it's covered.
Is it covered? I mean, like, it mattered, right? We've already shown a lot of... Wait, what is happening here? What is happening here?
Well, somebody finding out.
Okay, I'm just gonna...
say the word no. Like, I'm chewing on those vowels. I'm having a meal. I'm eating! No! Yum, true. I'm fucking full. I feel that shit. Deep in the back of my throat. I'm saying, let's go.
Do you understood anything she just said?
Do you not? She's speaking English.
I did not understand a word she just said.
You're not at a 2, girl.
No, I'm not good with accents. I don't know what she said.
Yum.
This time. She's saying when she says no,
okay,
she like extends it and like chews on every single no.
Oh, the word. Okay.
This time I had to use 10 pounds of garlic because 5 was just not lasting long.
I don't know what you're making and I don't need to know what you're trying to make, but just know that you're doing the Lord's work.
Whoa! Look at all this fire merch we could get! $49.99 worldwide shipping, Alluux?
Yeah, it's cringy.
Dude, look at all of this, though. What do you mean? Good luck shirts?
I know way better shops than this.
Like, name one.
Alluux.shop.
Cringe. You can dress like Criss Angel or... God, there's a lot.
Are you a weird little freak who lost all of your social skills during the pandy? Or maybe you never even had them to begin with, you absolute pervert. Here's a few tips to go from totally stressed to perfect guest. Never show up empty-handed. I brought a spoon for spooning and a fork for forking. Always compliment the host. I love your fat tits. And finally, don't forget to leave a parting gift. I hid a bunch of earwax under your pillows.
And with me being from Kentucky, I tell you one thing. You start making us get microchips, that way we can get our food out of the freezer or whatever, there's gonna be a lot of us country boys that's gonna stick a 12-gauge shotgun right up your ass. Maybe in your mouth.
If chills. Someone ever approaches you and tries to rob you, tell them to stop. Ask them, is it necessary? Is it nice? Do you have my permission? Tell them that you do not want to be touched. If they point a gun at you, tell them that it's illegal.
You think you could voice
true.
That's
true.
Illegal.
Based, true.
Short film scripts for you to try out. Debate this and show us if you're evil enough. Good luck.
Well. What have we here? A little lamb come to play with the wolf? You're just in time. I was just getting hungry.
You are no more significant than insects to me. I have conquered great kingdoms, defeated armies,
slain dogs. Some dark blood right here. So what is this? Is it dirt?
Now.
Look at that.
This is so painful.
There's no such thing as heroes and villains. We're all villains. It's just that those who live to tell the tale will always paint themselves as the heroes.
Men be like, I want a beautiful girl with big coconuts and a tight samosa. What about you, huh? What do you bring to the table? Or should I say under the table? Does it even touch the table? Bloody fucking 2 inches.
Fumes demonic. Have you seen this kid?
We've watched this. I think
I fucking love this kid, yeah. Dude. He's so... nothing cringe about him.
The Paris.
Looks like a frog.
He looks like... He reminds me of Ham.
I think like, that we've watched this video and said the same thing.
Thing. Yeah. Okay.
I think so. Yes.
Oh, man.
He's such a goober.
This one.
He's like 15, dude.
This one's better than any fragrance in my collection. Describe the notes. Sure.
Give me something.
He offers no information.
Magic dragon juice. If I don't turn invisible and start flying after I drink this, I'm returning it. Time for numbs. Brain freeze. As a Hufflepuff, I don't think I should be consuming this. Well, better have the sugar while I can. Sugar high activated. Epic moment. I am an alien, and you will listen to my commands.
Oh my god, I hate it so much.
This is like every I'm quirky. I just started streaming. Mm-hmm. This is path to affiliate in a person right here. Can I throw you a bone right now?
Me?
Yeah.
Do I need one?
No, you don't.
Okay.
But can I?
Yeah.
Okay. There is, okay. You know how people say Minions humor?
Uh-huh.
This is Minions humor.
This is so painful.
This is true. This is real Minions humor right here. And by the way, people, you can change her. No, you cannot.
You cannot. This is ingrained deep inside her. Just got saved.
Happy dance.
The only thing you do with this is tell her not to
Liza
talk.
What's her name? Liza Kosher?
Something like that.
It's her. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, but I've never seen anything she's done that is anything other than, she's like the carrot top of women, and that's not a compliment. It's horrible.
Koshi Koshi.
Recipe. I've been seeing this everywhere. This shit's so mean.
Yeah.
It's fucking face, dude.
Does he tell her it's good still?
Yeah, it's great.
It's just a little bit different. I think I just added maybe like 3 or 4.
Oh. He couldn't make it.
What do you say?
I don't want to turn it up.
Some more meat and sauce? There's lots of meat in there. And sauce.
Bro.
Oh no, I feel like the kettle.
Like it?
Damn, these young gentlemen. Are they nicer.
They love her.
I don't give a fuck who you love. My mother could walk that shit up to me, and I would spit it out and be like, bitch, what did you do?
Yeah, that's great.
Hostages? I'm more on the side of hostages. I gotta be real.
You can tell he's like, he looks at that and he goes, do I say yes? Yeah. And he's like,
do not say anything.
I love it.
I will say they are very, I'll say this. They're very sweet, mm-hmm. and I respect them for that. Fuck that. If it's that, think about how salty that must be. You need to tell her, bro.
Yeah.
Either way, king shit, though.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Bro, they deserve better. They deserve better. What is this woman doing to them? It's pretty good, he says.
One thing about me is that I am obsessed with the undersea fiber optic cables that connect the internet. I bet you're thinking, oh, Annie, cool microphone. You're so wrong. This is an undersea fiber optic cable. I can't believe you thought this was a microphone.
Whoa!
This bad boy looks like sushi. It's the girth of a sushi roll, and yet it can transmit 200 terabits of data every second. That's like all of Wikipedia, 250 times every second. And there's 486 of these in the world. They send little pulses of light.
This is not cringe. This is so cool and informational.
Through the fiber optic cables, it's literally crazy if you think about it too much. There's 486 in the world, and they sometimes break, and so they have to send a ship to repair them. This happens with like fishing and natural disasters, and occasionally sharks want to bite them, but luckily they're very reinforced. An increasing concern is terrorism, because like NATO recently said, what if Russia cuts up our internet cables? That would be a bummer. And like, how is this bad boy going to defend itself? It's just a little roll of sushi.
It's just a little roll of sushi.
Suddenly, I'm very concerned about underwater cable terrorism.
Suddenly, I'm actually very concerned that our internet
terrorists when I was a kid, you know, POV Saddam dancing to Hannah Montana. Okay. Terrorists when I was a kid. Terrorists when you're a kid. Fucking Navy SEAL looking dudes. Fish motherfuckers now. We went from sand to water, bro. It's crazy out there. The world is crazy out there, bro.
Do you think they're gonna cut our cables?
They might. I mean, that's what I would do.
One thing about me is that when I swim, my vagina fills up with water. And I had just met my ex-boyfriend, and we were training for an Iron Man. So we went to the pool to swim. Some laughs, it was very busy because it was a hot day. There was people everywhere and we were drying off. And I had nothing on from the waist down. So I said, sir, this will win you over. I want to show you a party trick.
No. No, no, no.
She pushed out all the water.
No, yeah, go back to the cable, ladies.
I bet your exes can't do. I stood like this and I pushed out the water onto the white pavement. But what I didn't know is while I was swimming, my period had come. And it was not water that left my body. It was about 3 parts water to 2 parts blood. The water just facilitated the spreading of the blood. There was blood everywhere, all down my legs.
Bro, I love it. It's like, hey, want to see a party trick? Oh my fucking god.
All over the pavement, and we were in a main thoroughfare, so we both looked at each other, burst into laughter.
He laughed.
And he just diluted it with a bottle of water at the end.
I wouldn't have laughed. I would think you're dying. I'd be like, oh my god, what the fuck is happening? Why? Immediately, I'd be like, oh my god, you're dying. And then once I realized you're not dying, I would walk away. Why did you just spray pussy blood
all over? Just walk away?
What do you mean?
Yeah, that's so bad.
What do you
They're
mean?
They're dating.
That was their first date, or they were just recently dating,
oh,
I thought.
Okay.
Well.
Whoa! Don't woe them. Don't woe them.
Dude, I'm going to be the next Hokage. That Tibio.
I did like those pants.
Okay. I'm going to be the next Hokage.
The blushie also got me.
That Tibio.
Did you see the blushie? Cheetos.
No. On Monday, we do chess. Because if you want your moose knuckle, rubbing up on her belt pocket.
Let me laugh.
That's very small. On Taco Tuesday, we do arms. Because if you want a thick mommy screaming,
I bumpy terminare in mi boca.
In the back seat of her.
That means finish in my mouth. Got you, boys. Stay strong. Ja, 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 ja. Does it not mean that?
Your arm better be swole. On Wednesday, we do arms. Because if you want a chick drinking your pecker porridge in the backseat of a TOS porridge, pure.
That's kind of funny.
On Thursday, we do arms.
Well, back to
if
arms.
If you want your bacon bazooka blasting goo on her labia in a GMC Acadia, your arms better be fucking small.
I don't find
on
these
Friday, we do
I don't
arms.
Either. Dude, he's done a lot of days of arms in a row. What, like, geez. And also, half of them have been on the tricep thing.
Trying to slam your beef gavel all up in her queep chapel. Your arms don't be fucking small.
True.
On Saturday, we do arms. Because if you want a thick mommy giving you roadhead till you explode on her forehead, your arms better be fucking small.
Every time it says, okay, look, this is going to be so, for no one, this is for no one but me. Every time it says it reduces fucking to FN, yeah. I think of FN, like the gun cup. No, okay.
On Sunday we back. Because if you want your pigskin bouncing off her chin, do you give her a frosty walrus at the Holiday Inn? Fuck is full.
Okay.
Is that her playing a tiny violin?
Yeah.
Take motherfuckers to read, bro.
I don't know.
Oh. Canada.
Or do they get slapped?
North Korea.
Do they get slapped?
South Africa. Babian.
Babian. That was anticlimactic.
France.
Why are they in like a dressing room?
Ireland.
Jerusalem. That's a city. Or a state. Wait, what's Jerusalem?
Thailand.
Uland.
Did he say Uland? You need another drink.
Well, yeah, you drink half it.
Can you get one? We got a new video coming up. Yeah. All right, give it up for Al. Okay, we're going to go to the next video. Wow, this one wasn't... I think what's cringe about this one is how fucking long it went on for. Give it up for Alex scooting away as I pull up the third one. No one's going to see your bum,
Alex. If I stood up, but if I didn't scoot...
Why don't you wear pants in this room then? Well, oh, boy.
My room is higher
camera. It's not safe to be breathing that. It's cringe because asbestos. All right, dude, the thumbnail for this one, I think we're in for a treat, boys. We're in for a treat. Show bum. Hey, chat, how you doing? It's just me and you now. It's just the boy. Now that it's just the boys, what do you guys want to talk about? We could talk about how cute you are. Boobs. I love the boobs. And I love... Hey, Swoljo! Oh, my God. He gifted 10 subs and I never saw it. That's so funny, though. Caleb, if you're still here, thank you.
Holy shit.
I didn't even thank him, bro. I hope he didn't see it. That's kind of funnier.
Hey, homie. Got myself a life and I am now back smile.
Good, I'm glad. There's going to be a bum on the screen? There's going to be a butt? Where? 4 months. Rant about Criss Angel again? You just want to hear me get all worked up. I have to pee so bad, but I'm going to be a man of the people and not pee until we're done.
I love you, but also I love you. Smile, love me back.
I love you too. Thank you. Well, thank you, Scrambone, for the 5. So poop on the bread. Can somebody put it here? I'm going to check the subreddit. Can somebody put it on the subreddit? It's definitely real. Right, he like just, again. It's not pleasant, but it's almost kind. He just poops on it.
Chainsaw Man
eats
was
it.
Fire.
Oh, it's here. Is this it?
Just wanted to say it was really nice meeting you.
It's nice meeting you too.
A long time and I really appreciate you stopping by to say hi at TwitchCon.
Thank you. You're of course, dude. I'm happy to meet you. Oh, shit. Wubby signed my autism card, and it increased my autism so much I had to go to the hospital. Okay, so here we are meeting. Okay, that's great. And now she's dead? What happened? Did you see that I killed her? Look, here she is. Here we're meeting. Yeah. Okay, dead.
She
did. I don't know. She literally said, Wubby signed my autism card, causing my autism to increase so much I had to go to the hospital.
What
imagine.
Does that
mean? I don't know. It's a bit cringe, though. Bit cringe. Imagine dying. All right, ready, Alex? Here we go. You ready? You got your drink? What you sipping on, Alex? Tell the chat what you sipping on.
Austin East Ciders Pineapple.
Where did you get
cider.
These? I've never seen these.
People send me them to the P.O. Box.
Okay.
I have like a bunch of different ciders that people
send me. I see that.
So
okay.
Hey, if you have ciders, send them.
Yeah. My favorite type of cider is when I come in cider.
You do that?
More cringe TikTok! Sorry, but Vor is in fashion right now.
What? Oh.
Do you know what Vor is?
Is that when you're like big and you eat people? Is that all it is? Oh. What is
it? I don't know. Oh.
Is that testicle?
That is. Freshly extracted. Why did you guess? Why did you guess? Did you really not know that was a kiwi?
No, I thought it was, I honestly thought it was like a coconut or something, like a weird, like, I didn't even think of what it was, but it squishing like that freaked me out. I didn't like it.
I can tell
it.
You got
it. Oh, she's lonely.
Oh, come on. That's going to get me to drink, dude.
Oh, no.
Cause I'm an albatross.
I would hate to be growing up right now. It's probably hard. There's too much ability to put something online that'll be there forever. Yeah. It's too easy.
Yeah, I don't like it.
Every kid walking around with TikTok in their pockets just making... I'm not trying to make fun of kids. We all had blunder years. Yeah. But our blunder years are gone to MySpace.
Yeah.
And maybe Facebook.
Yeah, I don't like it.
I'm so glad that, like, when I was recording that kind of shit, it was on, like, literal mini tapes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I used to think that a clown smashing a cream pie into someone's face was a hilarious prank until I realized that I, too, had been cream pied by clowns.
Oh, come on. That was kind of funny.
The audio cut just...
Hey, I don't want you to take this the
those
wrong way.
Jeans, bro. Whoa! Okay, kind of hot though. Kind of fire picks.
Those are
fake tattoos though. I'm gonna slap this man. I think they're fake. Kind of fire picks though. Cool, kind of fire. The picks
actually
look.
That first shot would be a great merch shot.
Which one?
The first one.
I don't want you to take this the wrong way, but
I kind of fire. Kind
I'd
of
buy
fire.
Those pants.
Kind of good fire. Photos.
Yeah.
Dude, the difference between cringe and not cringe is the person attractive. That's
I don't
it.
Think so.
I think a lot of the time
it's
it
sometimes,
is.
Sometimes.
Oh, you're right. That dude who like licked his hand. Yeah, you're right.
It could be hot. It's such cringe, bro.
That was some of those pretty good. The first one. They got one. God damn! Okay. Killing it. Don't call him Asmongold. Careful. Careful with that hand. What?
The hairstyle is just the choice of.
I don't know if he has much choice.
But I want more choice than that.
That's true. It's not stopping. It's not stopping. Oh, he
oh,
really
wait
needs.
For the turn.
He really needs to shave his head.
Yeah.
I think he needs to call it.
I think
it. Transformation? Body transformation?
I don't think so.
Does this person have Down syndrome?
What? No.
Hey man, I don't know if you're ready for that. That spinning move, great for your lats.
Does this person have children?
Why do you assume that? Oh my god, he does have a lot of kids' play toys.
It's like, are you the child living in the home, or are those for your children?
Oh, Jesus. Whoa! He's sheathing the sword. I took Kung Fu very briefly when I was a child, and we always sheath the sword because we're not violent outside the gym. You sheath the sword, respect everyone. Mm-hmm. He did the Marvel pose, too.
Yeah.
That was impressive, man.
Daddy. Actually, she's the daddy. She calls me the bitch.
Ew, what's I'm gonna get to the bottom of this.
This one's for all my baby girls. I see your comments, ladies, and they make me smile. I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
Whoa, whoa.
The tits scared me.
They scared me too.
Them.
I thought they were falling off.
Yeah.
You're right. You're right. You're right. Doesn't matter if they're attractive. That guy gives off vibes of like Bateman or whatever.
I swallow my gum.
No. No, you ever seen American Psycho where he's like fucking the girl?
Oh yeah.
And
yeah,
he's like
yeah.
flexing, but he's looking at himself in
yeah,
the mirror.
Yeah. Ugh.
Lean? We making lean bread?
Bread.
Lean bread? It's what the cool kids are doing.
I love lean. What is lean?
It's, I believe, okay, this could, I could really boomer myself right now, but I believe it's cough, like actual strong cough syrup or whatever, mixed with Sprite.
Okay.
So it's like scissorp or something.
Scissorp.
And I got codeine and Sprite, and I got the two, wow. I got the two cups. I got a foam cup in a foam cup, so it stays insulated.
Does it fuck you up or like?
Yeah, it's not good. Okay. It's like actually really dumb. Okay. It's really dumb.
I love lean. That looks like some soft ass bread.
That looks like good bread. That looks like some good. I would try
Thug
the
Thug loaf. Did you see that?
I would try the lean bread. I'm not gonna lie.
I found this like Mount Everest ain't got shit on me.
Cause I'm on top of the square. I think a necklace?
Oh, I thought it was like a hole into his chest.
I don't know why, but I blame anime for that. I feel like it's to blame.
I think that was some kind of character.
This is the heaviest song you will ever fucking hear! The heaviest song we have ever written!
Oh, come on.
What happened?
Oh, no.
My name is April. I'm 39 years old, and I am the host of the Allied Us system. My name is Mimic. My age is nobody's business, and I am a protector. I am also a black altar and a white body. My name is Spirit.
Wait, we can say that? I'm also a black altar and a white body. Here we go. Can we? Is that we cool with that now? What do you think?
I am a protector. I do not have an age because I am a ghost. I don't feel the body.
Hi, my name is Gidget. I'm sometimes 4 and I'm sometimes 6.
Oh, this is that DID.
Is this the same person?
Yeah. Okay. All right.
I am a ghost. I don't have a body.
Yep.
And sometimes in between. And I think that's it.
Hello. My name is Callie. I am a inner caretaker. Spend most of the time in the inner world, except when I am coloring our hair. I'm in my late teens. I'm an age slider. And I mainly take care of the littles inside the inner world. Hi. My name is Athena. And I mainly take care of the body, making sure that we eat, making sure that we go to bed on time and get sleep, and I lose a lot. I'm ageless, and that's about it.
Okay, one more? Yeah. One more?
Okay, one more.
One more. Well, let's see how long it is. Oh, I gotta piss. Alex, I gotta piss so bad. I gotta piss. So I'm not gonna pee. I don't fucking pee. I'm not a pussy. This one is so long. You can have that one for your stream.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
I appreciate it.
Yeah, okay, here we go. I got a little short, little spurt here. What is this one called? You cringe. Oh, this one's literally called You Cringe, You Drink.
This one might have been from P-Rex. She's been collecting TikToks.
Okay.
Every time she sees one, so she made this to upload it today.
This has 2 views. Someone in chat
uploaded
just said,
today.
Someone in chat just said, Wubby sits to pee. Did you tell him? Have you been saying that?
Was I not supposed to?
No.
Then no.
All right, You Cringe, You Drink. This one is curated by P-Rex. Mm. 6 minutes of pain.
Mm-hmm. Booyaka, booyaka, boom, 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 boom. Booyaka, booyaka, boom, 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 boom.
I've got the shoes, I've got the dress that makes me a princess, I guess.
Me when I can't sleep because I need to pee. God fucking damn it, I just wanted to go to bed. Now I have to go to the bathroom and interrupt that.
So accurate. I'll be sitting in bed. Me when I need to pee. Oh, I gotta pee. And I get up and I go pee.
Nah. Shit.
Getting hungry for some drama. Here, let me serve your bitch lasagna.
Bitch, lasagna. Bitch, lasagna.
That's a big
It's a big man.
Hi.
Hello. Tell me your gender pronoun.
Well...
First, I would like to say that no, it is not because I got too much hate and couldn't handle it.
That's cap.
Why you got so many lays?
I promise, I am okay. But I do appreciate all of the people that sent me kind words and lovely DMs, because it means more to me than y'all will ever know. And I truly love y'all, like, so much, like, for real. But I turned comments off because there's a bigger plan already in motion, baby! That only I know about.
Oh my god, say it! Speak! Oh, for fuck's sake. This guy is in every video too. But is this a Twitch?
I want a picture with Eduardo.
Oh no, that's a Comic-Con.
But I'm too broke.
Making coffee is harder than your 9-to-5.
Hear me out. First, you have to weigh out your coffee to the exact gram, and then you have to get it ground up. It is exhausting turning this crank over and over again. It is an absolute arm workout, and if you happen to be doing espresso, it's game over. Then, after weighing out your water and getting it heated up...
Hey, sorry, chat. Listen, I know you go to work and you work your ass off, but this meatball of a woman has to turn coffee for 5 minutes to... Did I just misgender?
I don't. No.
This meatball of a man.
This meatball.
I don't. I'm not.
You just called him meatball.
This fucking ball of meat.
You have to pour it out in circular motions over and over and over again until you reach the goal weight. The whole process can take 4 to 6+ minutes, depending on what brew method you're using. Just pouring water over and over. Then finally, after all that hard work, you can enjoy the cup. But man, I'm exhausted. I need a nap.
Mom, I can't shower.
Was that satire? I can't even tell.
I'm assuming.
It has to be, right?
My Discord kitten goes to bed.
There it is.
Oh, hi, Alluux.
Bro, you're tripping.
Hi,
the chick in your Discord who's talking to everyone who's ooh-wooing, bro.
They don't look like this, bro.
Trust me, bro.
Nitro, but I didn't see you boost the server.
I boosted Eric's.
You boosted your friend Eric's Discord server instead?
Yeah. Alluux?
What?
Okay, I know it's cringy, but that also looked kind of cool.
You haven't seen the real one on TikTok.
Oh,
some people actually be doing it really
that
well.
That looks really cool. Why your mouth like that?
Let's go! Here we go.
Older women are beautiful lovers. I said older women, they understand.
Sorry it took me so long.
Ooh, Hen, you'll never believe what happened.
No, I know.
There's a musical curse over Swell.
Yeah, I know.
And you'll never believe who did it.
Frankini? Yeah, I know.
Ooh, Hen.
I don't hate it. Do you hate it? I don't hate it.
Okay, it's fine.
Never believe how he did
the speakers.
It. He took control of the speakers.
Yeah, I know. And then put out a weird kind of frequency and now we have to sing.
Jasper.
Yeah?
It's cringe. It's very theater kid, but it's not,
yeah.
Like, but it's kind
of... There's some theater ones I'm like, oh, this could be in, like...
It's not horrible. We've seen worse. See, we could be this guy, you know?
This guy's a Chad. What do you mean?
He kind of is a Chad.
What? Why is camera so HD?
Can I tell you why?
Why?
If I had to guess, he's not using the front-facing camera, and he's got the flash on.
Yeah.
So that's literally why.
Okay, yep. I could see every blackhead.
He's like, oh, Journey came on? I got to film this video real quick, dude.
You can't even see.
He probably can't see shit.
Oh,
you got your glasses? Are you looking for? He can't see. I don't even think he knows he's recording.
Me when people don't want to hang out with me because of my autism. Fuck you, boring ass, fake ass bitches.
True.
Guess what I am? I'm special.
Yep.
I got superpowers and I'm unique.
Hey, oh, okay. All right, you got autism, kiddo.
I don't know
if you're super powered.
Geek.
This might be the weirdest collab ever.
No, this is.
What you say?
That is kind of amazing. Do you know what? That girl was in our first.
One.
She was in our first. Those two guys.
You are.
I am. She goes on for
the tongue is so.
Dude, we're making an extended universe here for Cringe You Drink.
That's true.
Those two guys I see on TikTok, they just do weird. They're like,
I don't know the other TikTok.
They're just
guys,
like wholesome. Like they're whatever.
Mm-hmm. She definitely has no teeth. I don't.
One, two, three, four.
cause I'm a kill, I'm a kill. So what you think of Mr. Raggedy Man? Doing all you can to look like Raggedy Ann.
Check you out, punk. Yes, I know you feel it. You look like one of those dancers from the Hanson video.
Aw, you're such a good boy.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you're so good.
Oh, this is TwitchCon.
Let me see, I wanna-
Yeah, you're so good.
Hello! What's good? Just hanging out by the rocks, another beautiful day.
Top three ways to kill yourself without feeling any pain. Number one, why didn't you stop scrolling, Pookie? Is everything okay at home? Does he hit you?
Three.
Okay, this might be the best video we've seen on
stop. What did it mean?
It's gotta be ironic. It's so funny, dude.
Every time somebody joins my live, I end up with the audio.
This is like the new thing on TikTok, by the way. I blame Ludwig. Where it literally is like, people are like, they'll post a video, they'll go live, they'll post a video that's like, if you join my live, this will happen. And they're live on TikTok. And it's created like a culture now.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so many people are doing it.
Every time somebody joins my live, I end up with the octopus on my girlfriend's head. Don't join!
I thought that was your mother.
I haven't had sex in so long, I'm afraid I'll forget how to moan. What if I fuck up and I bark?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, can somebody do me a huge solid? Can somebody send me? Oh, shit, hold on.
Wait, are you okay?
I'm fine. No,
don't
fart.
It's gonna reach me out. That sounded like you pulling like anal beads out of your ass.
You are period. Okay.
Ew.
What?
Don't sniff it.
I'm not.
I can hear you sniffing
no,
it.
No, you can't hear anything.
Yes.
Whoa, that's coming in clear.
Yes.
Real quick, so I'll be live Friday. I'll be all alone. It's kind of weird. We'll have to figure out some content. God knows. Oh, the jail crystal's charged. What was I going to say, though? Can somebody do me a huge favor and, like, rip the MP4 of just, like, a loop of just the girl dancing as the furry right at the end there. I want that to be my Discord profile background.
Wait, which
video.
One?
The furry girl dancing.
Oh, the
yeah,
I want wolf? That.
I want that to be my Discord background video. I fucking love it. It's so fucking funny, dude. Okay, I'll see you guys Friday. Thank you for watching. Hope you had fun tonight. I had fun. Thank you guys all for the gifted subs and the resubs. Mm-hmm. I appreciate you all. Thank you. Check out Alluux. She does this on her channel and she does it on YouTube. Alluux highlights. Step on itis. Thank you for the 5 subs. I got to pee so bad. Hope you guys have fun. Yo, by the way, Peanut Carlos, do you think we can make a highlight video out of the Criss Angel shit? It's pretty interesting. And we could try to ride the critical wave of it too.
Uh-huh.
You know, this is a conversation to be had off stream. I'll end stream.
Okay.
You are period.